46-44, and then there have been four ties, including a 35-19 Reddy's victory in Arkadelphia last season. Henderson State has won 10 of the last 11 meetings in this series. Arkansas Tech has not won a home game against Henderson State since 2006, and that was actually Crosstown Cyclone Stadium. That was the year we were renovating the home facility here for the Wonder Boys. And so you have to go back to 2005 to find the last time that Arkansas Tech defeated Henderson State at this facility. And so the Wonder Boys trying to shake off the recent history and pick up a win tonight against Henderson State, against their most frequent opponent, Ouachita Baptist, 86 meetings, Southern Arkansas, 85. The folks in purple and gray in Conway played them 84 times, UAM 78 times. But Henderson State, the most common opponent in football for Arkansas Tech, and tonight we get the 95th meeting. Kicking it away for Arkansas Tech to get us underway will be Austin Hosier, the junior place kicker, a transfer from Wagner College. Arkansas Tech wearing the gold uniform tops with the white pants, gold helmets with the Arkansas Tech logo on one side and each player's uniform number on the other. Back deep to return for Henderson State on the near side, it is Timian Jackson. And on the far side for the Reddies, it is Jalen Abraham. And we are ready for football here at Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium. Glad you're with us on the EAB Sports Network. The opening kick will come down to Timian Jackson at the 9-yard line. He brings it up the right hash mark, and he is taken down at the 25-yard line. Tackle made at that point for Arkansas Tech University, coming off the field with his number scrunched up a little bit. But it was Davion Vaison who made that tackle for Arkansas Tech, and it'll be first and 10 Reddies from their own 25-yard line. Henderson State comes into the night fourth in the conference in total offense, averaging 432 yards of total offense per game. It is definitely tilted a little more toward the pass in terms of their productivity. They average 289 passing yards per game. That is second best in the Great American Conference. And leading that offense is Andrew Edwards, last year's Great American Conference Freshman of the Year. A career 65% completion percentage for Edwards. He has passed for 2,715 yards, 27 touchdowns, and just four interceptions in 12 career games for the Reddies. He stands in the shotgun, receives the snap on first down, throws to the far side of the field, a sliding catch made at the 33-yard line, short of the line to gain, but it is a pickup of 8 on the completion to Jalen Abraham. Abraham comes into the night leading the Great American Conference in receiving yards so far this year at 119 per game, and he is a deep threat. He went underneath that time, but he averaged 26.4 yards per catch through the Reddies' first two games of the season. Second down and 2 for the Reddies from their own 33. Edwards fakes the handoff, throws far side, complete to Jackson. Timion Jackson is out of bounds with a Henderson State first down at the 37-yard line, a pickup of 4, and the first down of the night belongs to the folks in red and gray. Just underway from Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium in Russellville, Henderson State, all white, white uniform tops, white pants, and those familiar red helmets. On first down and 10 from their own 37, Edwards throws downfield and overshoots his intended receiver, Elijah George, who was streaking down the near sideline. But Edwards, rolling out to his right, put a little too much on that one, and it'll bring up second down and 10 for Henderson State. In the game at running back right now for the Reddies is Jaquarian Turner. Wonder Boys shuttle in some fresh defensive linemen. Also at the linebacker level, Matthew Minix has checked in. Among those checking in along that defensive line for Arkansas Tech, Hunter Half, a freshman out of Owosso, Oklahoma. He's at the right defensive tackle spot. Handoff to Turner on first down. He's got second down, I should say, and he's got some running room left. And we'll have a first down for Henderson State, a gain of 11 out to the 48-yard line. And there is an injured Wonder Boy over on the far sideline, slow to get up for Arkansas Tech. It is Lawson Howard, a junior defensive back from Little Rock, and a transfer from UAPB, and his injury will take us to a timeout on the field. 13 minutes and 47 seconds to play in the first quarter. No score between the Wonder Boys and the Reddies. In the Alathus Realty broadcast booth, we step aside for 1 minute. This is Arkansas Tech football on the EAB Sports Network.
At Phil Wright Autoplex in Russellville,
we know you have many places to buy a car. Our competitive pricing and no-pressure sales team
has made us your premier GMC and Chevrolet dealer in the River Valley for almost 50 years.
Our impressive inventory is changing daily. Shop online 24/7 at philwright.com.
For a simplified buying process, trust Phil Wright Autoplex. Great inventory, great prices, and an overall great buying experience. Exit 84 off I-40, Russellville.
Word is spreading fast about how fantastic the food is over at Ridgewood Brothers Barbecue in the big city of Russellville. Slow-cooked barbecue, quality meat done the right way. But did you know if you have a big event coming, we're talking weddings, maybe some people coming in from out of town for a business meeting that you really want to impress, Ridgewood Brothers Barbecue can help you out. Definitely hit up Grant and the gang over there at Ridgewood Brothers Barbecue for catering. Shane here with you once again for Ridgewood Brothers.
Back with you in the Olathe's Realty broadcast booth at Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium in Russellville as they continue to tend to the injured Wonder Boy over on the far sideline. We have the privilege of being joined by Kelly Davis, a member of the Arkansas Tech University Athletics Hall of Fame. And Kelly had a chance to have some new folks join him in that club last night. And Kelly, it was a great event over at Tucker Coliseum.
It was. What a wonderful event. I think we had, eight individuals, a 71 football team, and most all of them showed up, the ones that were able to be here with us, and they'll be recognized here at halftime, I'm sure, as you've already mentioned. But it was a great evening, and congratulations to all those inductees. I'm sure we'll have time to talk about some of them and even in more depth than you've already covered. But it was a great night.
And we're very glad to have you along for the ride tonight as the Wonder Boys look for their first win of the season against Henderson State. Kelly referencing those Hall of Famers that joined that club last night. They are Dana Aldrich Nichols from the softball program, Leon Anderson from the football program, but also just generally in terms of his support of Arkansas Tech Athletics as a community member over the last 40 years. Eric Burnett from men's basketball, also a member of the Arkansas Tech Board of Trustees for two terms. Heather Campbell, one of the all-time greats in Golden Suns basketball. Kevin Crafton, the most decorated pitcher in Arkansas Tech baseball history. Jalissa Gum Fisher, a dominant pitcher in softball. Tom Kamerling, who happens to be right over my left shoulder, longtime radio play-by-play voice and PA announcer here at Arkansas Tech. He went in last night along with Reagan Kenny, a boxer from back in the 1930s on campus. Carl Kuhn, who was an academic All-American, a three-time academic All-American at tight end at Arkansas Tech in the late 80s and early 90s. Bridget Piles Freeman, an accomplished volleyball player both in terms of athletics and academics. She one year won the Gulf South Conference Commissioner's Trophy, which was the top overall student-athlete award in that league, and certainly deserving of her honor last night, as was Marvin Shorty Salmon, who went in posthumously as a football coach. And the 1971 football team went in all together. And Larry Smith, the former sports information director here at Arkansas Tech, rounding out the class of 2023 for the Arkansas Tech University Athletics Hall of Fame. They have loaded up the injured Wonder Boy, Lawson Howard, on the Gator, and they will take him from the field as such, as Duke Walden evaluating him over on that far sideline after he was injured and deciding he was not going to be able to put any weight on his injured leg. And so they cart him off the field, and we will hope for the best for Lawson Howard. I believe that's the first time we've had a chance to call his name this season. And unfortunately, it is under negative circumstances as he is injured. And now it'll be first down and 10 for Henderson State from its own 48-yard line, 13 minutes and 47 seconds to go in the first quarter. No score as of yet between Arkansas Tech and nationally 23rd-ranked Henderson State. Mentioned the last time the Wonder Boys defeated Henderson State in this stadium. It was 2005, September 10th, 2005, to be exact. Final score that day was 42-32. Next year, after that, a much more low-scoring game, crosstown at Cyclone Stadium. The Wonder Boys won that one 7-6. That was the last time the Reddies left Russellville with a frown on their face. Edwards throws across the middle, catch is made at the 30-yard line. This will be enough for another Henderson State first down, as the receiver for the Reddies on that one was Caden Davis. He is stopped at the Arkansas Tech 28-yard line after a gain of 24, and it is first and 10 Reddies at the Arkansas Tech 28, and right now we are seeing the full brunt of the second-best passing attack in the conference. They'll keep it on the ground this time, and the Wonder Boys have it snowed under in the backfield. First man there to bust it up for Arkansas Tech was Braxton Johnson, the standout sophomore defensive lineman from North Little Rock. And then helping him complete the play was Ben Stiegel. They make the tackle at the 29-yard line for a loss of one. And it'll be second down and 11 for Henderson State from there. Carrier was Corian Burrell.
Braxton, 6 foot, 275.
Second down and 11 for Henderson State. Andrew Edwards in the shotgun. Two receivers to his right, one to his left. Takes the snap, throws, catch is made inside the 25-yard line. It's going to be short of the first down. Catch made for the Reddies by Elijah George. Ben Stiegel with another tackle for Arkansas Tech. They spot the football at the 22-yard line. And from there, it is going to be third down and 4 for Henderson State. A pickup of 7 on that pass from Edwards to George. Kind of a little bit of a flashback here tonight. The band is actually in the south end of the home stands rather than in the bandstand in the south end zone tonight. That's the way it used to be for years and years and years. And they have returned to that spot for at least tonight's game. Edwards throws to the near sideline. Catch is made by Timion Jackson. Jackson is forced out of bounds by Arkansas Tech's Christian Stafford.
It's going to be close.
They've got him down at about the 19-yard line. Yeah, they've already rolled to fourth down on the dial-a-down, and so it's fourth and one for the Reddies. Henderson State so far this year is 3 out of 4 on fourth down conversion tries.
Oh, big stop here would be good.
They're going to send in some extra beef up front, some extra blockers, telling you they're probably going to keep it on the ground. The Wonder Boys correspond with some more defensive linemen. Corey and Burrell will be the running back. Andrew Edwards is the quarterback on fourth down and one from the Arkansas Tech 19. They give to Burrell. Burrell goes up the middle, fights off an ankle tackle, stays on his feet, and will have enough for a Henderson State first down. Not a lot to spare, as the Wonder Boys were able to grab him around the ankle right at the point of attack. But Burrell able to fight through that and pick up the necessary distance for the first down.
About a half a yard extra.
They will spot the football at the Arkansas Tech 18. And it is first down and 10, Henderson State. From there, the Reddies, 8 out of 9 on red zone scoring opportunities this year. Only 5 of those 9 trips inside the red zone, though, have ended in touchdowns. And so I would imagine that's probably been a point of emphasis for Coach Maxfield and his offensive staff this week, finishing those drives and getting touchdowns rather than field goal tries. Maxfield throws toward the end zone, has a man, but overshoots him. Chris Hatzis, the LSU transfer, was the intended receiver. But beyond his reach, it'll bring up 2nd down and 10 for the Reddies. There with the coverage for Arkansas Tech, it was Tony McKay, freshman defensive back out of Jonesboro.
You got to keep your eye on him. Hatzis is only 5'9", 177 pounds, so he can get lost in the shuffle if you're not careful.
Jaquarian Turner is back in at running back for Henderson State. 2nd down and 10 from the Arkansas Tech 18-yard line. Edwards has 3 receivers to his left, 10:46 left in a scoreless first quarter. Hand off Turner, big hole up the middle, and has taken down a touchdown-saving tackle at the 5-yard line made by Christian Stafford, but it's a gain of 14 on the play, and it is first and goal Henderson State at the Arkansas Tech 4-yard line. Wonder Boys send in Trey White along that defensive line. Jyron Stewart checks back in at the linebacker level. Stewart had 13 tackles against Southern Nazarene last week. That was the most tackles by a Wonder Boy since November 9th of 2019 when Tyrus Fort had 16 tackles against East Central. Hand off to Jaquarian Turner. He tries the middle. It'll be stopped short of the goal line. A pickup of 3 on first and goal will make it 2nd and goal from the 1 for Henderson State as we go under 10 minutes to play in the first quarter. Henderson State received the opening kickoff, began this drive from its own 25-yard line. They've marched all the way to the 1. Now Turner on 2nd and goal is stopped short, slicing through to make the tackle for Arkansas Tech. It was Matthew Minix. Minix came into the night with 111 career tackles, junior linebacker out of Tulsa, Oklahoma. He had 2 tackles against Southern Naz last week. Now it's 3rd and goal from the 1. Hand off Turner, and this time Turner is no sign yet. Touchdown. Touchdown Henderson State on a 1-yard run by Jaquarian Turner. Turner gets his first rushing touchdown of the season, the 4th rushing touchdown of the year for the Reddies, and it is 6-0 Henderson State with 9:25 to play in the opening quarter.
Strong stand that time. Just, you know, when you get on the half-yard line, it's just almost impossible to stop somebody just from falling forward.
The extra point on its way and off the right foot of Colby King. It is good. Our new score with 9 minutes and 25 seconds to go in the first quarter is Henderson State 7 and Arkansas Tech 0. In the Alathus Realty broadcast booth, we step aside for 1 minute. This is Arkansas Tech football on the EAB Sports Network.
Why trust River Valley Tinting and Glass? Well, River Valley Tinting and Glass is a family-owned business, and they take care of their customers like family, too. So remember, your local auto, residential, and commercial glass and tinting company, River Valley Tinting and Glass. Check out their work on Facebook or call 890-5839 to get an estimate. Or you could always come by 2202 East 2nd Street to see all they can do for you. From a business you can trust, River Valley Tinting and Glass.
A lot goes into taking care of your property. You need equipment with more reliability, durability, and versatility built in. like number one selling Kubota BX and L Series compact tractors, Z Series mowers that deliver a quality cut, and Sidekick utility vehicles where durability meets speed. Visit your local Kubota dealer for a demo today. In the River Valley, see River Valley Tractor on Weir Road in Russellville.
Congratulations go out to the Golden Suns volleyball team, which picked up its first win of the season earlier this week against UA Monticello. The Golden Suns will get back into conference play this coming week, 6 p.m. Tuesday night at Southern Arkansas. You can follow live coverage of that match at ArkansasTechSports.com. And then Thursday night, the Golden Suns back at home, and the Henderson State Reddies will be the opponent, 6 p.m. Thursday at Tucker Coliseum. Golden Suns volleyball, no admission is charged.
That's a good thing. Come on out. Watch for free.
Set to kick it away for Henderson State after the touchdown drive for the Reddies to get this one underway is Axel Robertson. Robertson's kick, a line drive going toward the far sideline, and it's going to go out of bounds. And so Arkansas Tech will get the advantage of starting its first offensive possession of the night from its own 35-yard line. The Wonder Boys, eighth in the conference in total offense, averaging 291.5 yards per game. Eighth in rushing offense at just under 90 yards on the ground per contest, and the Wonder Boys averaging 202 passing yards per game. That is seventh best in the league. Henderson State, sixth in the league in total defense, fourth against the run, ninth against the pass. They do a really good job rushing the passer as they are tied for the conference lead in quarterback sacks, and so the Wonder Boys have to do a good job on first and second down. If you're in an obvious passing situation on third down, then the Reddies can pin their ears back and come after you. It's first and 10, Arkansas Tech from its own 35. Tay Gatewood in the shotgun, takes the snap, has some time, throws out in the near flat, complete to his running back, Deuce Wise, and Wise is going to be stopped for no gain. Tackle made for Henderson State by Jacob Neal. And it'll be second down and 10, Arkansas Tech from its own 35. Kelly, the Reddies have always been good defensively under Coach Maxfield.
Oh, they sure have. That's one of his specialties. He likes to coach that defense up, and he'll blitz at unopportune times, I tell you.
Hand off to Deuce Wise. Wise runs right. There was a hole opening up there for just a moment, but the Reddies did a nice job of closing it, and the man to close it for Henderson State was Tyler Strain, senior defensive lineman. He makes the tackle after a gain of four. It is third down and six, Arkansas Tech. Wonder Boys want to go quickly from their own 39. Four down linemen for the Reddies. Gatewood sets, throws across the middle, and it is incomplete, broken up for Henderson State by Cameron Thomas. And now, finally the penalty flag comes in. And I believe we're going to get pass interference against Henderson State. The Reddies sideline will not be excited about the delay in that flag coming out. But it came out nonetheless. And it'll be a first down for Arkansas Tech on penalty. All Arkansas Tech first downs brought to you by A Better Way Realty. A Better Way Realty, real estate done a better way. Penalties have been a problem for the Reddies. They average 75.5 penalty yards per game. That is fourth worst in the conference through the first 2 weeks of the season.
Well, let's hope they keep that up tonight.
8 minutes, 31 seconds to go in the first quarter. Henderson State 7, Arkansas Tech 0 from Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium in Russellville. Second of back-to-back home games for the Wonder Boys. Next Saturday night, we'll be down in Magnolia at Wilkins Stadium as Arkansas Tech will take on Southern Arkansas. Tonight, SAU is engaged in the game of the week in the Great American Conference. They are taking on Ouachita Baptist at Cliff Harris Stadium tonight.
And tied up.
Midway through the first, it is tied up in that one. Kelly will update us on the GAC scoreboard as we go throughout the night, as he always does. After some consideration, they have elected to spot the football at the Henderson State 49-yard line on that pass interference call against the Reddies. It is in a Better Way Realty first down. Dayton Keller checks in at tight end for Arkansas Tech.
Is that infamous spot foul or penalty foul?
That is it. Antonio Ruiz is in at wide receiver for Arkansas Tech. He goes to the far side of the field. Jorion Chase also in at wide receiver for Arkansas Tech. Chase enters the night with 90 career receptions for 1,117 yards. Gatewood, quarterback draw on first and 10, running right, and he is going to be stopped after a gain of a couple. Trying to find some running room out there, but there was very little of it.
Yeah, waited for that hole to open up, never did.
Cottrell Wallace, sophomore defensive end for Henderson State out of Bryant, made the tackle. Seems like about every other player in the GAC is from Bryant these days.
Yeah, Bryant or Benton.
They've produced a few.
Conway or some good athletes come out of there.
Second down and 8 for Arkansas Tech from the Henderson State 47. Here comes the rush. Gatewood throws downfield. It is incomplete. The receiver hit the deck. No penalty flag this time, as they're going to say that Jordan Jackson went down of his own volition.
Mm.
And it'll be 3rd down and 8, Arkansas Tech. Line of scrimmage remains the Henderson State 47.
Now hang on. There's still time for that flag to come
That's
out.
That's true. based on that first one, you kind of got to hold off just a little bit maybe tonight. 7 minutes and 52 seconds to go in the first quarter. Reddy's took the opening kickoff, marched down for a touchdown. Now the Wonder Boys trying to answer, but they face 3rd and 8. Need to get to the Henderson State 39 for the first down. In the shotgun, Gatewood takes the snap, rolling left. Still
find him,
rolling.
Find him. There
Just
you
throws
go.
Throws short to Dayton Keller. Keller is going to fight for the first down. It's
Got
in
it.
A Better Way Realty first down as Dayton Keller able to fight through the first contact from Jacob Neal and claw his way down to the 38-yard line for an Arkansas Tech first down.
Had a way to be patient. Very patient by Gatewood that time. Good job.
Now Tay Gatewood checks to the near sideline for the play call. Deuce Wise is the running back. Mason Ross is the receiver out to the left. 1st and 10, Wonder Boys from the Henderson State 38. Man in motion is the tight end, Dayton Keller. Just made that first down catch a moment ago. Gatewood fakes a handoff, throws across the middle.
Wow.
It is broken up, intended for Mason Ross, and very easily could have been intercepted by Cameron Thomas, who had both hands on the football but couldn't bring it into his body. And it'll be 2nd down and 10, Arkansas Tech.
Yeah, maybe, Sam, if he'd had a little loft on the ball, it would have maybe going right over that defender.
They're going to fix it. So the Wonder Boys are about to gain a yard on that incompletion, but they will get it corrected back to the 38 now.
We'll take it.
Every yard is precious. 2 receivers right, 1 to the left on 2nd down and 10, Arkansas Tech from the Henderson State 38-yard line. Midway through the first, Reddy's up 7-0. Gatewood wants to throw. To the right side of the
there
field,
you go.
Matthew Rivera
you
makes
go.
The catch, gets away from the first man, but not the second. Tackled after and a Better Way Realty first down inside the 25-yard line. Stop made for Henderson State by Kirby Owens, freshman defensive back. They will spot Rivera down at the 23-yard line, and it is a 1st down for Arkansas Tech.
Good positive thing right now, Sam, is that O-line is giving Gatewood plenty of time to find those receivers.
2 receivers left, Jordan Eddington in motion that direction. Gatewood hands it off to Deuce Wise.
Cut it up.
Wise is to the 20-yard line, stacked up there after a gain of 3. Leading the push defensively for Henderson State was Dylan Dambuki. And it'll be 2nd down and 7, Arkansas Tech from the Henderson State 20. The Wonder Boys are in the red zone where they are 6 of 7 on scoring chances this year, including 5 touchdowns, right in the middle of the pack in terms of red zone offensive efficiency in the Great American Conference through the first 2 weeks of this 2023 football season. Dayton Keller goes in motion right. Tay Gatewood calls for the football, hands it off to Wise, running room left, inside the 20, lowers his right shoulder inside the 15, and down to at least the 14-yard line goes
Real
Deuce
close.
Wise.
Boy, he's just giving him the 14.
Tim Jennings and A.J. Zarate were there for Henderson State.
About a yard short.
2nd down and 1, Arkansas Tech from the 14-yard line. Hand off Wise. Wise goes up the middle. He will have the A Better Way Realty first down. At the 10-yard line, a pickup of 4 on 2nd down and 1.
No, it's a bonus right outside the 10, so we'll have a chance for another one if we need it.
Even better. Checking out after making that tackle for Henderson State was Tyler Strain. It is 1st down and 10, Arkansas Tech at the 11-yard line after a pickup of 3. 5 minutes, 18 seconds to go, first quarter. Henderson State 7, and Arkansas Tech with a very methodical drive down the field now to try to even it up. 1st and 10 at the Reddy's 11, 2 receivers right. Ryan Wilkerson is in at running back. Fake a handoff to him. Gatewood running right. It's a running play for Gatewood, and he is tracked down from behind by Trenton Moore, junior defensive end. Makes the tackle at the 8-yard line after a gain of 3. It'll be 2nd down and 7.
Good. Positive yards out of that broken play.
Rivera came into the night 7th in the conference in passing this year at 184.5 yards per game. He checks to the near sideline for the play call on 2nd down and 7. Wonder Boys 7 yards from a 1st down, 8 yards away from a touchdown. Gatewood takes the snap. It's a quarterback draw. Goes up the middle and is spun to the turf after a very short gain. Got 1 yard to the 7. Tackle made for Henderson State by Jacoby Shell, freshman defensive end. Shell calls Forest City home. He had a redshirt year at Mississippi Valley State before transferring into Henderson State. So now it is third down for Arkansas Tech. Third down and 6 from the 7-yard line. 4 minutes to go in the opening quarter. Henderson State 7, Arkansas Tech 0. Glad you are with us tonight on the EAB Sports Network.
It is a little early, but you're almost going to have to match them score for score tonight.
Eddington and Mason Ross will be the receivers left. Matthew Rivera and Jordan Jackson are the receivers right. Whistles, timeout, Arkansas Tech. 3:44 to go, first quarter. In the Alathus Realty broadcast booth, we step aside for a 30-second break. This is Arkansas Tech football on the EAB Sports Network.
Score you on select in-stock wheels and tires now at R&R Tire Express. Get a set of wheels for just $6 and score the extra point with a set of tires for just $1 more. That's right, score a touchdown. Get the wheels and tires for just $7 right now at R&R. Just $7 gets you started on select in-stock wheel and tire packages. So get off the bench and get in the game. Score huge now at R&R Tire Express. Now open on East Parkway Drive next to Starbucks in Russellville.
3 minutes and 44 seconds to go in the first quarter at Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium in Russellville. We are joined right now in the booth by Bruce Duderstadt, member of that 1971 Arkansas Tech team that won the AIC championship, set a school record with 12 wins, and he and his teammates went into the Arkansas Tech Athletics Hall of Fame last night. There were a lot of highlights last night, but seeing that 1971 team together up there on that stage with their medals around their necks, that was a really special moment. The only thing that could have made it better if Coach Dempsey and Coach Severe were still with us.
Yeah, and we had lost a few, you know, Benny Shepard,
yep.
Rick Hampton,
no doubt.
Some of those. I wish they were here.
Third down and 6. Tay Gatewood takes the snap. He is in trouble, and there he goes. Down for a quarterback sack recorded for Henderson State by Dylan Dambuki back at about the 21-yard line. It's going to go for a loss of 14 yards. And that's going to make it a much longer field goal try for Austin Hosier. Hosier's first field goal try as a Wonder Boy came last week. It was from 21 yards against Southern Nazarene, and it was good. He is now 9 of 14 on field goal tries for his career, which includes his 2 years at Wagner College. This will be a 38-yard try from right between the hash marks. His career long is 42. A 38-yard try out of a hold by Aaron Wynn. The kick is away. It will be long enough. And it is good. And our new score with 2 minutes and 57 seconds to go in the first quarter is Henderson State 7 and Arkansas Tech 3. In the Alathus Realty broadcast booth, we step aside for a 30-second break. This is Wonder Boys Football on the EAB Sports Network.
Duval's Affordable Portable Buildings, the River Valley's oldest full-service portable buildings dealer. You'll find Burnett Affordable Buildings and C&H carports for garages, barns, carport sheds, and more. At Duval's Affordable Portable Buildings, they believe in high-quality buildings that last and excellent customer service that makes a difference. Visit Duval's Affordable Portable Buildings.com or just stop by 4151 South Arkansas Avenue in Russellville today.
2 minutes and 57 seconds to play in the first quarter. Henderson State 7, Arkansas Tech 3 after the 38-yard field goal by Austin Hosier as he improves to 2 out of 2 on field goal tries as a Wonder Boy. And now he will kick it back to Henderson State with just under 3 minutes to play in this opening quarter. Back deep for the Reddies again. Timione Jackson on the near side. And on the far side once more it is Jalen Abraham. Kick is away. It'll come down to Jackson. This time at the 5-yard line, out over the 10, the 15, stumbles there, makes his way up to the 20, dances around, penalty flag flies. He's out over the 25 to the 27, but the Reddies are going to end up starting this possession from long about the 8-yard line or so.
Because like a little hole, don't you think?
Yes, sir. And so that'll be half the distance to the goal from there.
Around the ankles.
And the penalty bug once again comes out to bite the Reddies here.
Well, it was awful quiet too, didn't it?
They will have to start from inside their own 10-yard line.
Have a moment of silence for this holding penalty.
They will move that one back. You're used to that, though, Kelly. It normally goes silent anytime you walk into a room. So,
yeah.
Out of respect,
now,
of course.
Now, go ahead and be honest. They're going, well, what are you doing here?
On that note, why don't you give us a GAC scoreboard update?
How about over in Searcy? Harding has a 14-6 lead over UA Monticello. Both of those teams are 2-0 in conference play. 3:31 left in the first quarter. Southern Nazarene has a 14-7 lead over Northwest Oklahoma. Wichita and Southern Arkansas still tied at 7, 4:54 left in the first. And East Central, 3, Southwest Oklahoma, 0. In that game, one of those teams is going to get their first win of the season.
Andrew Edwards, the quarterback for Henderson State, on 1st and 10 from its own 9-yard line. Got three receivers to his left. Setting up a pass to his right to his running back, though. That is Timione Jackson. Jackson is out over the 20 and up to about the 21-yard line. It'll be enough for a Henderson State first down on a gain of 12. On the pass from Andrew Edwards to Timione Jackson. Jackson, typically a wide receiver, but lined up at the running back spot that time. Now they will get their regular running back, Corian Burrell, back in the game. Burrell, last year for Henderson State, had 175 carries for 1,064 yards. And 14 touchdowns. As a result, he was an all-GAC second team selection. They hand it to him here on 1st and 10. He tries the middle, spins off one man, and then is taken to the turf by Blake Brown, freshman linebacker for Arkansas Tech out of Jonesboro, a graduate of Nettleton High School.
Just bouncing off of us right now. We're going to have to wrap up a little bit.
A gain of 5 to the 26-yard line. And it'll be 2nd down and 5. Andrew Edwards throws to the far side, screen pass, complete, Hatsis with it, hurdles the 35-yard line, makes his way out over the 40, and up to the 42-yard line, a pickup of 16 yards on the pass from Andrew Edwards to Chris Hatsis. Hatsis, that transfer from LSU, and it's 1st and 10 readies. And Henderson State really doing a good job spreading out this Arkansas Tech defense from sideline to sideline. They're picking up positive yardage right now. What they're really doing is setting up the deep ball, which they will go for eventually. Edwards throws to the right side. It is incomplete. He and his intended receiver, Hatsis, were on different pages, or perhaps, as Edwards points out, he believes that Hatsis was kind of pushed downfield by the Arkansas Tech secondary. Either way, it's an incomplete pass, and it'll be 2nd down and 10 for Henderson State from its own 42-yard line.
Where he threw the ball, no one was going to catch it.
Back in at running back, it is Jaquarian Turner. Three receivers right, one left into the short side of the field. They give to Turner. Turner, nothing up the middle, so he bounces it outside left. No outside contain there, and he's racing down the far sideline into Arkansas Tech territory, and he is tackled at the 35-yard line after a gain of 23 and another first down for Henderson State.
Yeah, it looks like Henderson got away with a real nice block below the waist right there.
1st and 10, Henderson State at the Arkansas Tech 35-yard line. Ball spotted on the left hash mark. Under a minute to go in the first quarter, Henderson State 7, Arkansas Tech 3 from Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium in Russellville. Edwards to throw. Rolling left, sees some room, goes for it, and will have the first down inside the 25 to the 24-yard line, a pickup of 11 for Edwards. Edwards came into the night 2nd in the league in passing at 289 yards per game, but he's also a running threat, as demonstrated by the fact that his total offense average is 331 yards per game, also 2nd best in the Great American Conference. Only DeMylan Brown from UA Monticello, the quarterback for the Boll Weevils, is ahead of him in both of those categories. We'll see DeMylan here at Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium in about a month. On 1st and 10 from the Tech 25. Handoff to Jaquarian Turner. Tries to get around left end. This time, excellent outside contained by Arkansas Tech. And that perimeter was established for the Wonder Boys by Blake Brown. And Brown able to make the tackle at the 22-yard line after a gain of 3, and that's the final play of the first quarter. After 15 minutes, it's Henderson State 7 and Arkansas Tech 3. In the Alathus Realty broadcast booth, we pause for 30 seconds. This is Arkansas Tech football on the EAB Sports Network.
When it comes to buying or selling a home, there really is a better way. As soon as you start talking with our team at A Better Way Realty in Russellville, you're going to feel the difference. Imagine if you had a great friend in the real estate industry, someone who genuinely cared about you and your family and was passionate about taking care of you. That is the philosophy of everyone who works here at A Better Way Realty. We want your business because we earn it, period. Discover what experience and heart can do with A Better Way Realty. Find us on Facebook and see the difference. A Better Way Realty. Real estate done a better way.
2 weeks from today, Saturday Showcase at Arkansas Tech University will provide high school students and potential transfer students with insight about the ATU campus in Russellville. Highlights will include opportunities for prospective students and their guests to interact with faculty members and current students, participate in an admissions application workshop, gain information about campus life, and take photos with Jerry the Bulldog, Arkansas Tech's campus ambassador. Saturday showcase check-in will begin on September 30th at 1 p.m. on the Craybaugh Hall lawn, and then beginning at 4:30 p.m., Saturday showcase attendees will attend a college fair with information about academic programs at Arkansas Tech. They'll also take part in our party at the plaza tailgating. It's all Saturday, September 30th, Saturday showcase. You can go to ArkansasTechNews.com right now, and the article at the top of the page will connect you with all the information you need. If you have a high school student, or if you are a high school student or looking to transfer to Tech and you want to join us for Saturday showcase 2 weeks from today. Andrew Edwards on second down for Henderson State takes the snap, steps up in the pocket, and is able to get rid of the football under a heavy rush from Kyle Green. Green had him wrapped up, but Edwards, with great strength. You heard Coach Shipp mention in the pregame interview how Edwards really looks a lot stronger this year as compared to a year ago, and we saw evidence of it right there as he was able to avoid the quarterback sack and get rid of that football incomplete to bring up third down for the Reddies.
Yeah, very tough. 6'3", 200 pounds. It's hard to bring down.
The line of scrimmage is the 22. They need the 15 of Arkansas Tech for the first down. Third and 7 for the Reddies.
Big play here, Sam.
Henderson State came into the night third in the conference in third down conversions at 48%. On third down, Edwards under pressure, avoids the rush. Now he's going to run for it. He will have the first down and more. Bounces it outside 10, 5, touchdown, Henderson State. A 22-yard run by Andrew Edwards with 14 minutes and 45 seconds remaining in the second quarter gives Henderson State a 13-3 lead pending the extra point. Wonder Boys were able to collapse that pocket down almost immediately, but once Edwards was able to avoid that rush, there just wasn't anybody at the second or third level who could catch him. Extra point on its way. It is good for Colby King, and our new score with 14 minutes and 45 seconds to play in the second quarter is Henderson State 14, Arkansas Tech 3. In the Olathe's Realty broadcast booth, we step aside for 1 minute. This is Wonder Boys Football on the EAB Sports Network.
Mr. Brake and Lube wants you to know when it comes to your engine, not all motor oils are created equal. That's why they only offer name brand motor oils that you can trust, like Pennzoil, Castrol, Mobil 1, and more. So don't pay top dollar for cheap generics. And if you're looking for work, Mr. Brake and Lube is hiring with all training provided and competitive pay. So call 219-5438 or visit 1415 East Main Street. Mr. Brake and Lube, your one-stop maintenance shop. Mr. Brake and Lube is an equal opportunity employer.
Today, Americans are more afraid of health care bills and the sickness causing them. Sadly, unaffordable premiums and deductibles leave many feeling insecure, confused, and afraid. Hi, this is Becky with HealthPlanLady.com, and no matter if you're self-employed, individuals, or families, you will be happy when you reduce your premiums, have no co-pays, and get a check after going to the doctor. Call or text now, 479-886-2475. That's 479-886-2475. HealthPlanLady.com. I'll treat you better.
Some statistics as of the end of the first quarter. Henderson State had 144 yards of total offense compared to officially here it shows 32 for Arkansas Tech, but I'm going to discount that a little bit because it seems like the one touchdown drive was longer than that, so probably having a little bit of a gremlin in the statistics program right now, so we'll set that aside for now. And Kelly will bring us a scoreboard update from elsewhere in the Great American Conference.
End of the first quarter, it is Ouachita 14, Southern Arkansas 7, Harding 21, UA Monticello 6, and almost the end of the quarter, it is East Central 3, Southwest Oklahoma 0. We got one game starts at 7 o'clock, and that is Southeast Oklahoma at Ouachita Baptist. I mean, Oklahoma Baptist, not Ouachita.
The other
I'm thinking ahead.
The other OBU.
Is that the Bison or the Bisons?
That would be the Bison, yes. But the Bisons won the Grammar Bowl last week when Harding beat Oklahoma Baptist. So. The kickoff by Axel Robertson will come down at the 5-yard line, fielded there for Arkansas Tech by Ryan Wilkerson. He's out over the 25, makes a man miss there, and is tackled from behind over the 30-yard line. The tackle made for Henderson State by Tim Jennings. And it'll be first and 10, Arkansas Tech, from its own 34-yard line. And Kelly, the kicker there, Axel Robertson, did his job, forced Wilkerson to catch it in the corner. But Wilkerson, nonetheless, able to turn it into a kickoff return of about 29 yards.
Yeah, he eluded two tackles right there. Good yardage.
Tay Gatewood leads the Arkansas Tech offense onto the field. 14:37 to go in the second quarter. Henderson State 14. Arkansas Tech 3 from Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium in Russellville. Gatewood hands to Deuce Wise. Wise goes up the middle and spins his way, a pirouette to the 37-yard line for a gain of 3. Tackle made for Henderson State by Zach Dixon. Dixon wears number 17 for the Reddies, a senior out of Baltimore, Maryland. And it'll be second down and 7 for Arkansas Tech from its own 37-yard line. Gatewood has the play call from the sideline. Three receivers to his left, including Will Stiegel. Man in motion is Matthew Rivera. He comes to the near side of the field. Now two receivers to either side. Gatewood looks right, nothing there. Looks left, throws there. Catch is made. First down. Reception made by Caleb Tannis, and he's free down the far sideline.
He's going to
go. Diving tackler can't get him. 15, 10, 5. Touchdown, Arkansas Tech on a 63-yard touchdown pass from Tay Gatewood to Caleb Tannis, and he displays his big play potential and gets the Wonder Boys their first touchdown of the night at the 13:46 mark of the second quarter.
Man, he turned and turned the burners on, didn't he?
One diving attempt at about the 30-yard line. That's the closest they came to catching him, but I don't believe already so much as laid a hand on him on that 63-yard touchdown pass from Tay Gatewood. Now Austin Hosier will attempt the extra point. Caleb Tannis with the long touchdown reception. And now the ensuing extra point on its way, and it is good. And our new score with 13 minutes and 46 seconds to go in the second quarter is Henderson State 14 and Arkansas Tech 10. In the Alathus Realty broadcast booth, we step aside for a 30-second break. This is Wonder Boys Football on the EAB Sports Network.
Quarterback, guard, running back. Every position has a role in building success. If you want a position where you can build success in your own career, Lexicon is hiring welders, millwrights, and many more positions. We offer free on-the-job training through our own Lexicon University so you can learn while you earn and build the career you want. Competitive pay, a great health care plan, paid vacation, a sweet 401k plan, and more. Find out more at lexicon-inc.com/football.
Caleb Tannis, 6'3", 215, a junior out of Kansas City, Missouri, and a transfer from Mid-America Nazarene in his first year at Arkansas Tech. He had 5 catches for 95 yards in week 1 against Oklahoma Baptist. Did not make a reception last week against Southern Nazarene, and now the 63-yard touchdown pass from Tay Gatewood. It is Tannis' first touchdown reception as a Wonder Boy for Tay Gatewood. It is his third touchdown pass of the season, and it is his longest pass of the season, the 63-yarder. Ensuing kickoff is fair caught inside the 5-yard line by Henderson State. Making that fair catch was Cameron Thomas, and it'll be first down and 10, Henderson State, from its own 25-yard line after a fine kickoff by Austin Hosier, again angling it toward the corner.
Yeah, I did a good job. And that pass, that long pass for the touchdown, just kind of talks about the defense, Henderson's pass defense that you mentioned before the game. What would you say, ninth? Ranked ninth?
Yes. Yeah, they
in the conference?
They've been a little receptive to the pass.
So if we can give our quarterback a little bit of time the rest of the night, we'll have our chances.
The Reddies have allowed over 250 passing yards per game through the first 2 weeks of the year. You were listening earlier.
I was. Yeah,
that's pretty good. Andrew Edwards in the shotgun.
I think they were fourth in rush defense.
My goodness. Must have had your vitamins today.
Mercy.
First and 10, Henderson from its own 25. Hand off to Corey and Burrell. Burrell around right end. Looks like he had his vitamins. He's out over the 35 and up to the 40-yard line. A pickup of 15 for the all-conference running back for Henderson State. Tackle made for Arkansas Tech by Tyreek Jones. It's another first down for the Reddies. They're 11th of the game. And it's first and 10, Henderson State, from its own 40-yard line. This is the third time that the Reddies have had the football. The first two resulted in touchdowns. Edwards throws near side, complete to Timion Jackson. Jackson hemmed in there, hit by Bershad Richardson. He stays on his feet through that contact, but not through the second, as finishing off the tackle for Arkansas Tech was Kyle Green. Green, the junior defensive lineman out of Bryant.
Tackle for a loss. That's awesome.
Back to the 37-yard line for a loss of three, and it is second down and 13 for Henderson State. Edwards from the shotgun, two receivers to his right, two to his left. Ball spotted on the left hash mark. The Reddies moving from our right to our left toward the Burkle berm and the hole building. Deep ball, far side. It is overshot. Intended for Timion Jackson, but double coverage there for Arkansas Tech. Running with him stride for stride were Matt Arnold and Josh Thrower. Thrower, a freshman defensive back for Arkansas Tech out of Little Rock. And a graduate of North Little Rock High School.
Big third down, Sam. We could get to maybe get a stop here and turn some of that field possession down.
12 minutes and 34 seconds to go in the second quarter. Henderson State 14, Arkansas Tech 10. And Andrew Edwards in the shotgun with three receivers to his right, one to his left. They need the midfield stripe for the first down. Edwards rolls to his right. Throws, catch is made, running toward the first down marker, but not getting there. It is Jalen Abraham preventing him from reaching the line to gain for Arkansas Tech.
You never know.
It was C.J. Palmer on the tackle.
Looks like Henderson may be going for it.
Here comes the punt unit after some consternation.
Yeah. It's maybe a little too early.
Spotted at the Henderson State 48, so it is fourth down and two. Now the Wonder Boys rush their punt return unit onto the field. The punter for the Reddies is Colby King. Now they send a man in motion toward the far side. Got to be aware of the possibility of a fake here. King averaging 41.2 yards per punt this year. End-over-end kick. Catch is made at the 18-yard line by Tyreek Jones. He is immediately snowed under there, but credit Tyreek for having the courage to come up and catch that football. Probably saved the Wonder Boys perhaps 10 or 15 yards in field position.
That was an end-over-end punt. And you know when it was going to hit about the 18-yard line, it could have easily stopped inside the five.
So the Wonder Boys get the ball back, first down and 10 at their own 20-yard line as the Arkansas Tech defense comes up with its first stop of the night. And now the Wonder Boys get the ball back, trailing 14-10. Tay Gatewood, 4 of 6 passing so far for 87 yards and a touchdown. Two receivers to his right. One to his left. Man in motion is Jordan Eddington. He lines up the right halfback. Gatewood rolling right, throwing. It is intercepted the 28-yard line and out of bounds with it for Henderson State is Josh Brown. Tay Gatewood has improved so greatly in protecting the football this year. Turnovers were a problem for him last year. That is just his second interception through the first 3 weeks of the year. The bad news is it gives Henderson State outstanding field position as the interception by Josh Brown will set Henderson State up first and 10 at the Arkansas Tech 22-yard line.
Yep, this defense is going to have to help us right here.
The interception by Josh Brown is his first of the season. Only the second interception as a team this year for Henderson State. It comes with 11 minutes and 46 seconds to go in the second quarter. With Henderson State leading 14-10, and now that Tech defense that was feeling good about itself, and rightfully so, after getting the stop on third down, now they have to go right back on the field with their backs to the wall. Penalty flags fly before the snap. And nope. Apparently a play clock issue, but they have gotten that addressed now, so no penalty.
Oh, well, we penalize the clock operator.
I guess they have to run a lap after the game. 11:46 to go in the second. First and 10, Henderson State from the Arkansas Tech 22. Jaquarian Turner lines up to the right of running back Andrew Edwards. Edwards hands it to Turner.
Wrap him up.
And Turner is stopped by Blake Brown. We've called the freshman's name quite a bit in the early going. And the Nettleton High School graduate, first man there for the Wonder Boys to make the tackle for a loss, perhaps. Also helping out on that stop for Arkansas Tech was Hunter Half, freshman defensive lineman from Owosso, Oklahoma.
Yep, Blake Brown, 6'1", 205.
It ends up going for no gain to the 22. So it is second down and 10, Henderson State. Quarterback Andrew Edwards, 9 of 14 passing for 82 yards. Wants to throw again toward the end zone, but wide of his target. He had Jalen Abraham inside the 5, but Tyreek Jones was there as well, and I think that flash of gold influenced Edwards to throw that one away. So now it's third down and 10 for Henderson State. And this Tech defense is perhaps one play away from getting another stop and forcing Henderson State into a field goal try after the Arkansas Tech turnover. 11 minutes and 10 seconds to go in the second quarter. Reddy's with the ball and a 14-10 lead. Corian Burrell in motion out to the right. He'll set up as a wide receiver. Edwards looking left, rolling left, throwing downfield to a wide open man. Did he get a foot down inbounds with the football? Yes, he did. Says the official on the near side. Now the official on the other official says maybe not so fast. The first official who had the primary look at it said catch and then touchdown.
Maybe he was out.
As Timmyone Jackson was the intended receiver. Now let's see what we've got. Kyle Shipp has thrown the red flag for a challenge.
Well, he thinks he's out of bounds when he caught the ball, maybe.
Kyle Shipp has thrown the challenge flag if they do indeed rule this a touchdown, which was the initial call from the official who was closest to the play, but then another official came in and he was saying not so fast. So they are likely going to go over to the video setup here and take a look at this
one. Well, hopefully they'll decide it and he'll be able to save his challenge.
And so now four officials are going to talk it over. Now a fifth will join in. Coach Shipp wants to make sure they've seen that challenge flag. 11 minutes to go in the second quarter. Henderson State 14, Arkansas Tech 10.
Hopefully incomplete pass.
Leave the man.
What do you think, Sam?
It was
close.
I'm looking at it through green and gold glasses, of course, but at full speed, it sure looked like his foot came down out of bounds. But
I think they're discussing where he can save his challenge and call it incomplete. What do you think, Sam? Come on. Here we go. Incomplete pass.
So they
saves the challenge. There we go.
So they ruled an incomplete pass, so no touchdown for Henderson State. Instead of a touchdown, it'll be fourth down. And if the Reddies elect to try a field goal from here, it would be a 39-yard try. Henderson State, so far this year, has seen both Colby King and Axel Robertson attempt field goals. King has been the more common of the two. King is 2 out of 3. But neither of them have made a field goal longer than 30 yards so far this year. This would be a 39-yard try if that is the will of head coach Scott Maxfield. But first, I think Coach Maxfield wants an explanation.
Well, he may challenge now.
Maybe he can challenge. He very well may.
Saying, hey, I want to look at it now.
He wants an explanation from the referee first as to why it was ruled a touchdown, and then they overturned it without forcing Arkansas Tech to use a challenge. And I don't blame him for wanting at least an explanation on that point.
In either case, it was a close call.
Here comes the referee to let us know what Coach Maxfield has reported. His red flag is out.
He's going to challenge it now.
Okay, so Henderson State will challenge. They think it's a touchdown. And so they're going to go down to the south end zone.
Way down there.
Close to the visitor locker room. That's where the review setup is. And while they do that, here from the Olathe's Realty broadcast booth, we will step aside for a one-minute break. This is Arkansas Tech football on the EAB Sports Network.
ABC Children's Academy is currently enrolling with 14 locations in Pope, Johnson, and Yell County. ABC provides all-day child care, as well as a variety of enrollment options for families, including Arkansas Better Chance for ages 3 to 5, plus more. Visit abcchildrensacademy.com for more info and come by their central office on 4th Street in Russellville to apply in person or call 567-5650. ABC Children's Academy, changing our world one student at a time.
Experienced installers needed. That's right. Arkansas River Valley Heating and Air is needing experienced installers. Candidates must have a minimum of 2 years' experience with HVAC installation, must have a valid driver's license, and be able to pass a drug test. Serious inquiries only. Contact Arkansas River Valley Heating and Air at 479-964-4004 or drop off a resume at their office. Arkansas River Valley Heating and Air is an equal opportunity employer.
Doris Kosich will perform the 2023 John and Trudy Watson Classical Guitar Series concert at Arkansas Tech University on Thursday, September 21st. The concert will begin at 7:30 p.m. in Witherspoon Auditorium. Admission will be free and open to the public. This event is sponsored by the John and Trudy Watson Annual Classical Guitar Series Endowment and the ATU Department of Music. It's Doris Kosich with the 2023 Watson Classical Guitar Series Concert Thursday night at 7:30 in Witherspoon Auditorium. Scott Maxfield's challenge was denied. After they looked at the review, they did not have any evidence to overturn The call of an incomplete pass on the try from Andrew Edwards to Timion Jackson, and so it will be a 39-yard field goal try for Henderson State.
Still don't think he's very happy about that call.
The kick is on its way, and it is
no good.
Wide right off the foot of Colby King from 39 yards. Could not quite hook it back inside that right upright, and the Arkansas Tech defense turns away the scoring threat created by the Wonder Boys turnover. And what a job we've seen from the Arkansas Tech defense now on back-to-back possessions, stop, or at least slowing down this Henderson State offense that came into the night fourth in the league in total offense and second in pass offense. And two possessions in a row, the Arkansas Tech defense has turned them away. So it'll be first and 10 Arkansas Tech from its own 22-yard line. Tay Gatewood is the quarterback. Deuce Wise is the running back, with Henderson State leading 14-10 and 10:53 to go in the second quarter. Gatewood has the snap, sets up a screen, complete to Jordan Jackson. Jackson is wrestled to the turf at the 25-yard line after a gain of three. Tackle made for Henderson State by Colby Crawford and Randarius Terry. It'll be second down and seven, Wonder Boys from their own 25-yard line. Arkansas Tech goes over 100 yards of total offense on the night, 101 yards to be exact. Henderson State sitting at 189 yards of total offense thus far. On second down and seven from their own 25, Wonder Boys run a quarterback draw. Gatewood runs left. They'll be stopped at the 28-yard line after a gain of three. Tackle made for Henderson State by Zach Dixon and Trenton Moore.
Third and four.
And it will indeed be third and four for the Wonder Boys, who are two out of three on third down conversion tries so far tonight. Will Stiegel is back in the game at wide receiver. He and Caleb Tanis go to the left side of the formation. Matthew Rivera and Jordan Jackson are the receivers right on third down and four. Wonder Boys need their own 32. Gatewood with the snap, throws across the middle, in and out of the hands of his intended receiver, Will Stiegel. And that'll force the Wonder Boys into a punting situation on the incomplete pass. Aaron Wynn leads the Great American Conference in punting so far this year at 48.3 yards per try, which is impressive, especially considering the fact that he had to leave the season opener with a jammed hip, but he bounced back in a big way last week against Southern Nazarene, punting three times for an average of 48.7 yards per attempt against the Crimson Storm.
Need a big one right here.
Wynn with 169 career punts at the collegiate level, a career average of 39.6 yards. Bit of a line drive kick here under a heavy rush. Fair catch is called for and made at the 26-yard line for Henderson State by number 26, Devin Adams. And Henderson State will go back on offense there. First and 10 from their own 25, now they rule, after a 47-yard punt from Aaron Wynn. And before this change of possession, we will turn it over to Stephen Berry in the EAB Sports Network studios for a station ID. This is Wonder Boys Football on the EAB Sports Network.
This is Arkansas Tech Wonder Boys Football on River Country 102.3 KCJC, Dartanelle, Russellville.
Andrew Edwards in the shotgun for Henderson State. He has completed 9 of 16 passes for 82 yards. Timion Jackson has caught 4 of those passes. Handoff.
Oh, hold.
Burrell on first down. He goes around left end. It'll be forced out of bounds by Tyreek Jones.
Number 64 in the white jersey was holding like crazy. No call.
The run by Burrell goes for a gain of 14 out to the Henderson State 39-yard line, despite the objections of both Kelly and head coach Kyle Shipp, both of whom saw the hold.
Oh, that allowed the running back to get around the corner.
Burrell with his third carry now for 46 yards.
That's what they call a textbook's hold.
Three receivers right. Edwards rolling that way, throws, catches, in and out of the hands of the intended receiver for Henderson State. Jalen Abraham was the intended target of that pass, but C.J. Palmer came in at just the right moment to collide with that intended receiver, jar the football loose, and now bring up second down and 10 for Henderson State from its own 39. 8 minutes and 59 seconds to go in the second quarter. Henderson State 14, Arkansas Tech 10. As has been the case the first 2 weeks, the Wonder Boys right in the fight, just looking for a handful of big plays to make the difference. Edwards awaits the snap. Looking left, throwing left, Abraham, this time able to make the catch, but wrapped up short of the line to gain by Tyreek Jones. Freshman defensive back for Arkansas Tech out of Crossett. Jones has him stopped at the 46-yard line after a pickup of 7, and that makes it 3rd-and-3 for Henderson State. Edwards looks to the far side for the play call. Elijah George, along with Timione Jackson, will be receivers to the right side, as well as Chris Hatzis. The lone receiver left is their leading receiver, Jalen Abraham, the same man who just made that 7-yard catch a moment ago. Faked handoff. Edwards will run for it. Across midfield into Arkansas Tech territory, runs over Tyreek Jones, and then Willie Miles makes the tackle at the Arkansas Tech 38-yard line. It is a gain of 16 yards for Andrew Edwards on the quarterback keeper, and Henderson State moves the chains once more. It is the 13th first down of the game for Henderson State. Reddies are now over 200 yards of total offense as we play here midway through the second quarter. Edwards with three receivers left. Handoff goes to Jaquarian Turner, and he had absolutely nowhere to go.
That was nice.
First man into the backfield for Arkansas Tech was Kyle Green. He plugged it up. And then coming through to clean it up for Arkansas Tech, Javon Love, Tyshawn Nelson in on that stop. A loss of 1 back to the Arkansas Tech 39 makes it 2nd-and-11 for Henderson State. That is already the 3rd tackle for a loss tonight for the Arkansas Tech defense. Edwards takes the snap. In trouble. Hit as he released. Complete anyway for a 1st down at the 25-yard line. Elijah George making that catch. And again, we see that improved physical conditioning and strength from Andrew Edwards that Coach Shipp mentioned in the pregame interview to be able to stand in and deliver that pass on target under that kind of pressure and absorbing that kind of hit at the moment that he let go of the football. That was pretty impressive.
That was all on him right there.
They spot the receiver George down at the 26 with a gain of 13 and another Henderson State 1st down. Edwards throws a screen, complete near side to Timione Jackson. Jackson makes his way down to about the 20-yard line. Stop made for Arkansas Tech by Matt Arnold. Arnold came into the night with 58 career tackles, a junior from Texarkana. He had 3 tackles last week against Southern Nazarene. His career high for tackles in a single game is 5, which he has achieved on 4 different occasions. The stop at the 21-yard line makes it 2nd-and-5 for Henderson State. Jaquarian Turner is the running back, 2 receivers right, 1 to the left. That one man left is Jalen Abraham, ball spotted on the left hash mark. Reddy's moving from our right to our left toward the Burkle berm, handoff. Running left with it, 15-10. Turner is forced out of bounds at the 5-yard line by Willie Miles. It'll be a gain of 16, and Henderson State has it 1st-and-goal at the Arkansas Tech 5-yard line with 5 minutes and 57 seconds to go in the second quarter, and Henderson State threatening to add to a 14-10 lead. Wonder Boys shuttle in a whole bunch of fresh defenders, 6 of them, now 7, many of them along the defensive front, as Henderson State has gone to a jumbo package here. Jaquarian Turner is the running back, and some confusion for the Reddies on the personnel grouping, and head coach Scott Maxfield calls timeout. 5:32 to go, 2nd quarter. Henderson State leads 14-10 in the Olathus Realty broadcast booth. We step aside for 30 seconds. This is Arkansas Tech football on the EAB Sports Network.
Johnny Story in with a thought from Olathus Realty. With years of experience, knowledge, and a network of relationships, they ensure you'll get the most for your house. So when it comes time to put that property on the market or begin looking for that next dream home you have, don't delay. Call Brent Pretty and the professionals at Olathus Realty Russellville, 968-5668, or check them out, russellvilleliving.com.
Our congratulations go out to the Arkansas Tech University Department of Nursing, the faculty, the staff, the students, and the alumni from that academic program, as earlier this week, it was announced that the half-century tradition of nursing education at Arkansas Tech will continue after the Arkansas State Board of Nursing granted continued full approval of the ATU Bachelor of Science in Nursing degree. So congratulations to Dr. Shelley Daly, the head of that program, and everyone else associated with the nursing program here at Arkansas Tech, which goes all the way back to 1975 and really has made a difference for healthcare in this part of the country.
Very good program. as well as many programs at Arkansas Tech.
And you can learn more about those at atu.edu. 5:32 to go in the second quarter. Henderson State 14 and Arkansas Tech 10. When play resumes momentarily, it's going to be first down and goal for Henderson State from the Arkansas Tech 5-yard line. Reddies so far tonight have gotten touchdowns of 1 yard on a run by Jaquarian Turner and a 22-yard run by quarterback Andrew Edwards. They were set up in very much of a jumbo package, looking like they were going to run it again before they had to call a timeout. It seems like this timeout has gone on.
Yeah, I'm not sure what's going on.
Much longer than usual.
Media timeout.
Could be. Yeah, those darn media folks, they always slowing things down.
Got to pay the bills. Pay the bills.
Absolutely. 5:32 to go in the second quarter. And Andrew Edwards brings the Henderson State offense. And the Reddies hope a less perplexed Reddies offense back onto the field on first and goal from the 5. Jalen Abraham is the receiver left, one receiver right. Handoff, and there to greet the ball carrier is Braxton Johnson, the sophomore out of North Little Rock, able to drop Jaquarian Turner for a loss of at least 2 back to the 7-yard line. It'll be second down and goal for Henderson State. Braxton Johnson of Arkansas Tech University came into the night already with 5 career tackles for a loss, and he adds to his total there. Let's spot it at the 8-yard line. It's second down and goal from there for Henderson State. Edwards in the shotgun. One receiver to either side gives to Turner again. Turner tries the middle, and again, the Wonder Boys answer.
Good job.
Stop made for Arkansas Tech by Blake Brown and again Braxton Johnson. No gain on the play.
Just, 2 running plays. Tried to keep that defense honest. Now watch for the pass.
And now
be careful.
Now it is 3rd and goal from the 8. Reddies make a couple of changes. Wonder Boys get some more defensive backs into the game now as a pass becomes much more likely on 3rd and goal from the 8. 2 receivers left, 1 to the right for quarterback Andrew Edwards. Edwards brings a man in motion, Timione Jackson. Edwards rolls the pocket that way, throws into the end zone. It is caught, but he was out of bounds. Caught out of bounds over on the far side, trying to get a foot down in bounds with the football was Jody Easter, but unable to do so. Yep. And so we will see the field goal unit again for Henderson State. This will be a 25-yard try.
Much more manageable.
It'll come from the left hash mark, the same spot from which Colby King missed earlier. That was a longer kick, though. That was, I believe, about a 39-yard try earlier. This will be just 25. Kick is on its way. It is good. And our new score with 4 minutes and 13 seconds to play in the second quarter is Henderson State 17 and Arkansas Tech 10. In the Alathus Realty broadcast booth, we step aside for 30 seconds. This is Wonder Boys Football on the EAB Sports Network.
Arkansas Tire and Auto Service, we're more than just tires. Consistent, responsive, honest and fair. What makes us different? We're the ones who care. Trust our experience to know what you need. Professional and fast, see what we mean. Arkansas Tire and Auto Service, we're more than just tires.
Arkansas Tire and Auto Service, 2304 East Main, Russellville.
17-10, Henderson State is the new score following the 25-yard field goal by Colby King. It capped a 12-play, 67-yard scoring drive for Henderson State that consumed 5 minutes and 25 seconds. The Reddies have about a 2-1 advantage so far in time of possession in this one. The Wonder Boys right in the fight with 4 minutes and 13 seconds to go in the second quarter. Some good stops, a couple of them inside the 20-yard line by the Arkansas Tech defense, once holding Henderson State to a missed field goal, now holding them to just 3 points on the Colby King kick. And it's only a 7-point lead for Henderson State as we near halftime. And the performance by the Arkansas Tech University Marching Band, known far and wide as Arkansas's Band of Distinction, under the direction of Dr. Daniel A. Belanger in his 9th year at Arkansas Tech. And we will carry the halftime performance by the Band of Distinction for you in just a few minutes.
You know, Mr. Cooper was here. They used to have Battle of the Bands.
Yes. Henderson State would always...
Yes, they'd always come up.
We would typically reciprocate back in those days. Axel Robertson will kick it away for Henderson State. It will come down to Ryan Wilkerson at the 5-yard line. He's got three blockers out in front to the 20, to the 25. Hemmed in by A.J. Zarate.
Maybe a little face mask, possibly.
Penalty flag comes in. Wilkerson was tackled at the 27-yard line by Zarate.
Looked like a face mask anyway.
Now we'll see what the penalty flag is about. Kelly thinks
When your head kind of goes almost all the way around.
That's a pretty telltale
sign.
Pretty
good sign. Yeah.
We'll see if the man in the white hat agrees. He does, but it's against Arkansas Tech. Nope, now he's saying.
Oh, I was about to say, whoa, wait a minute here.
Now he corrects himself and says it's against Henderson State.
Thanks. Thank you for that correction.
And so that'll add 15 yards onto the end of that Ryan
Wilkerson
run.
Now, he cannot complain about this.
He's going to. Coach Maxfield, that is. He wants an explanation, at least. Going to move the football out to the 41-yard line, we believe. The man in the white hat has gone over to hear from Coach Maxfield, and it appears that he's heard all he wants to hear. And they will move the football up to the 41-yard line, and it'll be first and 10 Arkansas Tech from there. With 4 minutes and 4 seconds to go in the second quarter, Henderson State 17, Arkansas Tech 10. The Radies came in ranked number 23 in the nation at the Division II level, 2-0 to begin the season. Arkansas Tech 0-2, having lost to Oklahoma Baptist and Southern Nazarene by a combined total of 9 points.
Oh, they were talking about timeouts.
Okay.
Being able to, they thought they had three timeouts or one left, and now, but they do have two. They made that correction, I think.
Tay Gatewood sends Ben Stiegel in motion toward the far side of the field. Gatewood wants to throw on first and 10 from his own 41 across the middle and incomplete, intended for Matthew Rivera. And I'm glad to see that one hit the turf. There were four Henderson State players right in that vicinity. 4 minutes left until halftime.
Was a lot of white jerseys.
Tay Gatewood now 5 of 10 passing for 90 yards, one touchdown, one interception. Gatewood in his fifth year at the collegiate level played 3 seasons at East Central University. Came to Arkansas Tech, began last season as the starting quarterback, and then was replaced just shy of the midpoint of last season by Jack Grissom, and Grissom went pretty much the rest of the way at quarterback for Arkansas Tech. Will pitch out to the left for Ryan Wilkerson. He cuts it upfield, but right into the waiting arms of a Henderson State defender. And that ready tackler was Paul Manning, a sophomore defensive back out of West Monroe, Louisiana. He stops Wilkerson for a loss of 2 back to the 39-yard line. It'll be 3rd down and 12 from there for Arkansas Tech, and the Wonder Boys yep. in danger of a 3-and-out that would give the football back to the Reddies right before halftime.
Might want to put that play back on the shelf.
3rd down and 12. Arkansas Tech so far tonight is 2 out of 4 on 3rd down conversion tries. Running yards have been hard to come by here tonight. Just 12 rushing yards thus far for Arkansas Tech compared to 149 for the Reddies. Pass is complete to Rivera. Rivera into Henderson State territory. 35-30. It's a foot race to the 20. 15, 10, 5. Touchdown, Arkansas Tech on the second touchdown pass of more than 60 yards tonight by Tay Gatewood. This one a 61-yard strike across the middle to Matthew Rivera, and the Wonder Boys are an extra point away from tying it up late in the first half.
Mercy. Another one turned the burner zone.
Matthew Rivera with his 9th career touchdown reception at the collegiate level. It is his 3rd at Arkansas Tech, including 2 this year. Rivera came into the night with over 1,200 career receiving yards between his work here and his work at Presbyterian College. And now Austin Hosier will try to tie the score. Placement is down. Kick is away. It is good. And our new score with 3 minutes and 5 seconds to go in the second quarter is Henderson State 17 and Arkansas Tech 17. In the Alathus Realty broadcast booth, we step aside for 30 seconds. This is Wonder Boys Football on the EAB Sports Network.
Farmers Co-op located in Russellville. Don't forget their Danville location. Mike Apples along. Mike, it is that time of year when feed is very, very important.
It sure is, and make sure that you've got your animals' needs taken care of, protein levels met, and all those things that you look for when it comes this time of year.
Farmers Co-op, we're located on East Main in Russellville. Don't forget their Danville location.
The scoring drive for Arkansas Tech, 3 plays, 59 yards. It only took 59 seconds and resulted in the 61-yard touchdown pass from Tay Gatewood to Matthew Rivera. The 61-yard catch is Rivera's longest as a Wonder Boy. His previous long in an Arkansas Tech uniform was a 50-yard reception last year. Gatewood has thrown his two longest passes of the season here tonight, a 63-yard touchdown pass to Caleb Tannis earlier in the second quarter, and now a 61-yard strike to Rivera with 3:05 left in the second quarter, and it has tied the score at 17. Now Austin Hosier set to kick it back to the Reddies. High short kick. It'll come down at the 14-yard line. Fair catch called for and made there by Cameron Thomas.
Yeah, he'll gain 15 yards on that fair catch. 10 yards. He caught it on the 15, didn't he?
He did. 3 minutes and 4 seconds to go until halftime.
My bad, Sam. My bad.
Hey, you can make up for it with a GAC scoreboard update.
I tell you what, Ouachita is letting Southern Arkansas back in the game. It was 28-7. Now Southern Arkansas has scored twice, 28-21, 3 minutes to go in the first half in that game. And East Central still holds that 3-0 lead over Southwest Oklahoma. Southern Naz, 27-7 over Northwest. And Harding 35, UAM 12.
First and 10, Henderson State from its own 25. Andrew Edwards steps up in the pocket. He will run for it. Block in front to the 30, the 35, and up to the 37-yard line goes Andrew Edwards. Matt Arnold with the tackle for Arkansas Tech, but a couple of nice blocks downfield by wide receivers from Henderson State, springing Andrew Edwards for that run.
Our defensive backs, they have got to get away from those receivers. They just got to. If they're holding them, they've just got to break loose.
First and 10, Henderson State from its own 36 after a gain of 11. Two receivers left, two to the right. Wonder Boy show blitz, so Edwards looks to the far sideline, and the Reddies will make an adjustment with 11 on the play clock. Edwards claps his hands, takes the snap. Here come the Wonder Boys. They pick it up. It is deflected and almost intercepted right through the hands of Jyron Stewart. At the 40-yard line, had a chance to pick that one off. I'm not sure he was even...
I thought he had it.
I'm not sure he was even aware the football was there. It kind of more just hit his hands by accident.
I thought he kind of looked around like, do I have the ball still?
He was as surprised as anybody.
So close.
So it's second down and 10 after the incompletion. This time, three receivers right. Edwards rolling that way. Throws. Catch is made by Timione Jackson. Jackson is forced out of bounds after a pickup of 5 to the 41-yard line.
Big third down here.
There defensively for Arkansas Tech were Javon Love and Tyreek Jones.
Well, we got third and 5?
You got it. Third and 5 for the Reddies. They are 3 out of 7 on third down conversion tries so far tonight. Edwards looks to the far side for the play call. Three receivers to his left, one to his right. The one to his right is Elijah George. Ball spotted on the right hash mark. They're moving from our right to our left. Edwards throws.
Incomplete.
Intended for Timione Jackson across the middle, but there were several gold jerseys there to break it up, led by Matt Arnold.
There was a lot of gold jerseys that he threw into.
And so Henderson State will punt it away with 1 minute and 41 seconds left in the second quarter.
We've got two timeouts left.
And the score tied at 17. Here late in this first half from Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium in Russellville. The kick is away. Angling toward the far sideline, takes a big Henderson State bounce and roll.
Just what they needed.
The Colby King punt is out of bounds at the Arkansas Tech 17-yard line. That makes it a 42-yard kick for King. And the Wonder Boys... Interesting thought process here for Don Maroc, the offensive coordinator, and Kyle Shipp, the head football coach. You do have the two timeouts left, a minute 32 to go, but you also get the football to begin the second half. And so I don't see the Wonder Boys being hugely aggressive, given the fact they're starting from their own 17. Maybe if you can get a first down or two, then you can take some shots.
These first two plays right here will tell the tale for the rest of the half.
Tay Gatewood in the shotgun. Deuce Wise is the running back. They're going to throw it. Gatewood across the middle, caught by Caleb Tanis.
There you go.
Tanis is taken down.
First down.
Tackle made for the Reddies by Tim Jennings.
Clock will start.
It is enough for an A Better Way Realty first down for Arkansas Tech.
Have some good yardage there, Sam.
Tay Gatewood on first down takes the snap. Looking, throwing across the middle. It is broken up by the aforementioned Tim Jennings.
Boy, he timed that one just right, didn't he?
Intended receiver for Arkansas Tech was Will Stiegel.
That was very close.
And so now it's second down and 10, Arkansas Tech from its own 27.
Minute 11. Still got time to get down at least field goal range.
Austin Hosier's career long on a field goal try, a successful one at least, is 42 yards. So that would mean you need to get to around the 25. Gatewood throws. Catch is made by Stiegel.
Go. Out of bounds. Good job. Stop the clock.
Zach Dixon forces Stiegel out of bounds. Short, it appears, of the first down, and that is the case at the 34-yard line. A pickup of 7, and it's third down and 3 Arkansas Tech. 1 minute, 8 seconds left in the second quarter. Gatewood throws across the middle, broken up.
Mercy. Oh, game of inches right there.
It's probably a touchdown if Cameron Thomas doesn't leap and deflect that pass intended for Caleb Tanis.
There was nobody.
Nobody
back there.
Nobody between Caleb Tanis and the end zone. But Cameron Thomas, with a touchdown saving play, deflects it away. And so instead of a touchdown, it's fourth down. And now the Wonder Boys have to punt it away on fourth and 3 from their own 34 with 1 minute and 1 second remaining in the half. Deep snapper for Arkansas Tech is Gregor Jones. Gregor wears number 88, a freshman out of Sugar Land, Texas.
Looks like they're lined up to try to come for it.
Aaron Wynn's punt is away.
But they let it go.
It is caught at the 21-yard line, and returning it out to the 26-yard line, it is Devin Adams. And so the punt by Aaron Wynn travels 45 yards and just a 4-yard return, and Henderson State will go back on offense, first and 10 from its own 25 with 50 seconds left in the half. And the score still tied at 17 here at Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium in Russellville. Hope you'll join us next Saturday night. We'll be at Wilkins Stadium in Magnolia. Another 6 p.m. kickoff as Arkansas Tech will visit Southern Arkansas, the 86th meeting between the Wonder Boys and the Mule Riders. Next Saturday night at 6 p.m. right here on the EAB Sports Network. Wonder Boys trying to get set defensively. Henderson State goes quickly, and they throw a pass complete to Timione Jackson on the far sideline. Andrew Edwards with his 14th completion of the first half. And it'll bring up second down and 2 for the Reddies.
And be careful. They've got plenty of time.
Line of scrimmage is their own 33. They are not particularly adept in the field goal category, though, so they may need to get down around the 15 to have a legitimate shot. Catch is made by Chris Hatzis out near midfield. It'll be a Henderson State first down. Chris Hatzis on the reception from Andrew Edwards. A gain of 17 to the midfield stripe. And it's first and 10 Henderson State from there. 32 seconds left in the half. Clock rolling. Edwards sets to throw deep. It is deflected, incomplete. Batting that one away across the middle for Arkansas Tech. It was the freshman linebacker Blake Brown who's had himself an outstanding first half here tonight for Arkansas Tech.
Well, one positive thing, Sam, you're saying freshman quite a bit.
A lot of young ones stepping up and making plays for Arkansas Tech, particularly on the defensive side of the ball. Second down and 10, Henderson State from the 50-yard line. 28 seconds left in the half. Two timeouts for the Reddies. Edwards throws near side, catch is made. Angling for the sideline and getting there out of bounds. It is Timione Jackson. He has a first down on a gain of 15 to the Arkansas Tech 35. And now the clock is rolling, and that's in error. And so they will have to address that. Coach Scott Maxfield not super happy about things over on the far side.
Well, it's not. The clock operator was looking at the official down here, and he was winding the clock.
Okay.
So I don't know. I think he got tackled in bounds and then went out of bounds. So they were winding that thing, but now they're putting a little bit back.
So the Reddies use a timeout. We will step aside for a 30-second break. This is Arkansas Tech football on the EAB Sports Network.
Taking care of families. That's what the folks at C&D Drugstore have been doing in historic downtown Russellville for more than six decades when it comes to all your pharmaceutical needs. When it comes to compounding special medicines, R.D. Walker and his staff are there to serve you. And most importantly, if you need delivery, if you need curbside pickup, you need C&D Drugstore on the corner of B and Commerce in downtown Russellville, a 60-year tradition.
Andrew Edwards, 3 of 4 passing for 40 yards on this drive to move Henderson State down to the Arkansas Tech 35-yard line with 21 seconds left in the half. The Reddies have one timeout remaining. Wonder Boys show a middle blitz. Here they come. Reddies pick it up. Now pocket collapsing. Edwards rolls left, and we'll just throw this one away into the boundary. Pressure applied for Arkansas Tech by Vershad Richardson. It'll bring up second down and 10 for Henderson State. The line of scrimmage remains the Arkansas Tech 35 with 16 seconds to go in the half. Absolutely huge from a momentum standpoint if the Arkansas Tech defense can get one more stop here right before halftime. Line of scrimmage is the Tech 35, 16 seconds left in the second quarter. Edwards sets to throw, puts it up to the far sideline. It is incomplete with 10 seconds left in the half. Intended receiver was Timion Jackson. Looked like that one came out of Edwards' hand a little awkwardly. And the incompletion will make it third down and 10 for Henderson State.
Kind of floated a little bit.
Down to 10 seconds now. You would expect the Reddies to maybe take a shot to the middle of the field around the 15-yard line and try to get the clock stopped with their last timeout to set up a field goal try. It's either that or throw it into the end zone. That's about their two options at this point with 10 seconds left in the half. It's Edwards on the quarterback draw, 30, 25, 20, and tackled from behind at the 15-yard line, so they get exactly the 20 yards they needed. They got it on the ground, though, rather than through the air, surprising Arkansas Tech with that call, as Edwards on the quarterback draw gains 19, and they use their final timeout with 3 seconds left in the half. We will keep it here through this break in the action with 3 seconds left in the second quarter, and Arkansas Tech and Henderson State tied at 17 as the Reddies fooled everybody with that play call there, Kelly, to go with the quarterback draw, but it paid off.
It sure did. It was a wide open lane, too.
It sets up what will be, we believe, a 33-yard field goal try by Henderson State place kicker Colby King. King, so far tonight, has missed from 39 yards. He was good from 25. If they do go through with the field goal try, it would be 33 yards from the left hash mark, and that will be the case. Colby King, a junior out of Houston, Texas. He is a transfer from Kilgore College. He'll be trying a 33-yard field goal to give Henderson State the lead at halftime. Placement is down. Kick is blocked. It's blocked. Rolling
it
free at the 20-yard line. The Wonder Boys scoop it up. Running with the football, Matt Arnold. Arnold to the 35, the 40, and he's tripped up from behind. A penalty flag comes in. We'll have to wait and see what that is before we know whether or not the half has come to an end. A penalty flag is down as the Wonder Boys blocked that field goal try.
If it's against the kicking team, then we'll get a free play right here.
Let's see what we've got. The clock has expired here at the end of the second quarter, but they've got to sort out what this penalty flag is about. Half cannot end on a penalty. Kyle Shipp, the head football coach of Arkansas Tech, is out for a preliminary indication from one of the officials as to what the penalty flag is about. They're also discussing it with Scott Maxfield over on the far sideline.
Yeah, it's probably against us then, blocking the back or something.
That looks like the case. Henderson State's heading to the locker room. They're going to decline the penalty and allow the half to come to an end. Blindside block against Arkansas Tech. That is declined, and the first half has come to an end. And through two quarters of football at Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium in Russellville, we have settled absolutely nothing. Our score is nationally 23rd-ranked Henderson State 17 and Arkansas Tech 17. We will step aside in the Alathus Realty broadcast booth for a three-minute break and then come back for the halftime show by the Arkansas Tech Marching Band, tied at 17 at halftime. This is Arkansas Tech football on the EAB Sports Network.
At Centennial Bank, we believe serving our
continuously challenged in the 52 years since, made it all the way to the NAIA National Championship game, the 1971 Wonder Boys, inducted into the Athletics Hall of Fame at Arkansas Tech University as a team last night, and then being honored here tonight by the crowd at Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium. And it is great to have them in attendance here tonight and watching so far what has been a great effort by the Wonder Boys as they and Henderson State are tied at 17 at halftime. Henderson State with 331 yards of total offense so far compared to 180 for Arkansas Tech. The Radies have 152 passing yards, 179 rushing yards. Arkansas Tech with 168 passing yards thus far, just 12 yards on the ground thus far for Arkansas Tech. Henderson State has 19 first downs, 7 A Better Way Realty first downs for Arkansas Tech. The Reddies are 4 of 9 on third down conversion tries. Arkansas Tech is 3 out of 6 on third down. Henderson State has maintained possession of the football for 19 minutes and 20 seconds compared to 10 minutes and 40 seconds for Arkansas Tech. The Wonder Boys have 4 tackles for a loss, 2 tackles for a loss thus far by the Henderson State defense. Individual leaders first for the Reddies. Quarterback Andrew Edwards has completed 16 of 30 passes for 152 yards. He is also the Reddies' leading rusher. Edwards, 5 carries for 78 yards and a touchdown. Jaquarion Turner has 12 carries for 67 yards and a touchdown for the Reddies. And Timion Jackson with 8 catches for 49 yards leads the Henderson State receiving corps. For Arkansas Tech, offensively, Tay Gatewood, the quarterback, 8 of 15 passing for 168 yards, 2 long touchdown strikes, 1 of 63 yards to Caleb Tannis, and 1 of 61 yards to Matthew Rivera, accounting for both of Arkansas Tech's touchdowns thus far. And then on the ground, it's been Deuce Wise with 5 carries for 19 yards for Arkansas Tech. Rivera and Tannis with 2 catches each for Arkansas Tech. Rivera, 76 receiving yards. Caleb Tannis with 73 receiving yards thus far. Defensive leaders, first for Henderson State, it is A.J. Zarate with 5 tackles. Arkansas Tech led by Ben Stiegel with 6 tackles. Christian Stafford and Blake Brown have made 5 tackles apiece for Arkansas Tech. And then Willie Miles, Kyle Green, and C.J. Palmer all have 4 tackles for Arkansas Tech. Here in the Olathus Realty broadcast booth, we will step aside for 30 seconds and then come back for the halftime performance by the Arkansas Tech Marching Band. That's in 30 seconds. We're tied at 17 at halftime, and this is Arkansas Tech football on the EAB Sports Network.
Watch your money grow with First State Bank's My Rewards Checking. Earn 4% APY on balances up to $25,000 and nationwide ATM fee refunds. Plus, First State Bank makes banking easy with mobile banking and drive-through banking 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Don't wait. Make the switch. Earn more interest with My Rewards Checking. Now, qualifications must be met to earn 4% APY. If qualifications are not met, the account will earn 0.05 APY that statement cycle. First State Bank, member FDIC.
Taking the field here at Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium is the Arkansas Tech University Marching Band, Arkansas's Band of Distinction, under the direction of Dr. Daniel A. Belongia, Director of Bands and Professor of Music at Arkansas Tech University, as well as Dr. Jonathan Nash, who is the Assistant Professor of Music and Associate Director of Bands at Arkansas Tech University. And now taking the field, it is the Arkansas Tech University Marching Band, Arkansas's Band of Distinction. The voice of the band is Dr. John Clements.
Stronger than to be realized, not despite the difficulties, but made all the more significant because of this matter. Together, we are stronger than anything we stand in the way of our dreams. We are stronger than, and we are your Arkansas Tech University Band of the Sixers! Unbearable and unreachable. Our quest, no matter how hopeless, is to be willing to give when there's no more to give, so that the world may be a better place, because we strive with all our might to reach the unreachable star. This is the impossible dream. Thank you.
That is the Arkansas Tech University Marching Band, Arkansas's Band of Distinction. We are tied at 17 at halftime. And here from the Alathus Realty broadcast booth, we will pause for 3 minutes and then come back with more halftime. This is Arkansas Tech Football on the EAB Sports Network.
Hey, it's Drew Mitchell for Lakeside Oral, Facial, and Dental Implant Surgery. Lakeside is really proud this year to be sponsoring our local sports all throughout the River Valley. They're committed to the area. It's just another way they show that. When you're in the market for dentures, wisdom teeth, or whatever the case may be, remember Lakeside Oral, Facial, and Dental Implant Surgery and check out their website at lakesideofs.com. Lakeside Oral Surgery, helping make the broadcast of local sports throughout the River Valley possible.
At Liberty Car Wash in Russellville, you have options. You can wash your car yourself or drive through one of the automatic car washes. Liberty Car Wash also gives you the option of washing your fur baby. Why make a mess in your home and risk clogging your drains when you can wash Max at Liberty Car Wash? Visit Liberty Car Wash today on Knoxville Avenue and South Arkansas Avenue in Russellville, where you always have options.
Miller Roofing Company, a family-owned company treating you like family. Who's a part of the Miller family of employees? Tony Martin is construction supervisor.
I go out and I look at whatever projects people may be needing done, whether it's additions, remodel work. On the construction end, a lot of times people, they have a vision of what they want, and what I try to offer them is my experience in this field. We just like to do the best that we can for our customers.
Your friends at Miller Roofing. See them on South Arkansas in Russellville and follow them on Facebook.
At Phil Wright Autoplex in Russellville,
we know you have many places to buy a car. Our competitive pricing and no-pressure sales team
has made us your premier GMC and Chevrolet dealer in the River Valley for almost 50 years.
Our impressive inventory is changing daily. Shop online 24/7 at philwright.com.
For a simplified buying process, trust Phil Wright Autoplex. Great inventory, great prices, and an overall great buying experience. Exit 84 off I-40, Russellville.
Word is spreading fast about how fantastic the food is over at Ridgewood Brothers Barbecue in the big city of Russellville. Slow-cooked barbecue, quality meat done the right way. But did you know if you have a big event coming, we're talking weddings, maybe some people coming in from out of town for a business meeting that you really want to impress, Ridgewood Brothers Barbecue can help you out. Definitely hit up Grant and the gang over there at Ridgewood Brothers Barbecue for catering. Shane here with you once again for Ridgewood Brothers.
Why trust River Valley Tinting and Glass? Well, River Valley Tinting and Glass is a family-owned business, and they take care of their customers like family, too. So remember, your local auto, residential, and commercial glass and tinting company, River Valley Tinting and Glass. Check out their work on Facebook or call 890-5839 to get an estimate. Or you could always come by 2202 East 2nd Street to see all they can do for you. From a business you can trust, River Valley Tinting in Glass.
We are tied at 17 here in Russellville with Arkansas Tech and Henderson State. And now with an update, what else is going on around the Great American Conference football? It's Kelly Davis.
Well, coming into tonight's action, Sam, we had five teams that had a 2-0 mark, but that is going to change because four of those teams are playing each other. And these halftime scores, other than our 17-17 tie here, it is Ouachita Baptist 35, Southern Arkansas 21. Both of those teams are 2-0. And it is Harding 35, UA Monticello 12. Both of those teams are 2-0. So there will be some movement in the standings after tonight's contest. East Central has a big 3-0 lead over Southwest Oklahoma at the halftime. And the other scores that we have to report in the second quarter, we're not sure exactly. It may have gone to halftime, but our computer is frozen up on us. But Southern Nazarene has a 27-10 lead over Northwest Oklahoma, and that was with 6 minutes to go in the first half. And the game that started at 7 o'clock, it is now Oklahoma Baptist just now scoring again. They have a 20-3 lead over Southeast Oklahoma. Oklahoma Baptist, our first opponent this year, they are 1-1 in conference play. Southeast Oklahoma looking for their first win. And the other ones, Southern Nazarene, 1-1. Northwest Arkansas, 0-2. So, and East Central, Southwest Oklahoma, one of those two teams will get their first win tonight. They are playing each other. And it's very possible we may see three undefeateds go down tonight if these Wonder Boys can hang on and play a great second half like they did the first half.
Thank you for joining us for the halftime show. It is now time for the second half kickoff here at Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium. Glad to be with you from the Alathus Realty broadcast booth here at Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium. Our pregame show tonight brought to us by our friends at Lexicon. First downs are sponsored by A Better Way Realty. Every Arkansas Tech extra point is brought to you by Mr. Brake and Lube. Mr. Brake and Lube, when you need an auto repair shop, you can count on. And then our post-game show is sponsored by Health Plan Lady. And we hope when it gets around to Health Plan Lady post-game show, we are celebrating the end of a long streak for Arkansas Tech. The last time the Wonder Boys defeated an opponent from inside the state of Arkansas was September 9th of 2017. And for whatever it's worth, that night in Arkadelphia, it was a nationally ranked Henderson State team that went down to Arkansas Tech, and the Wonder Boys trying to bookend that with another win over a nationally ranked Henderson State team here tonight in Russellville.
That was week two, I believe. This is week three, so doesn't make any difference.
It just get the win. That's the main. All that matters right now in these next two quarters of football, and put that inexplicable streak to bed. High short kick, fair catch is called for and made just across the 25-yard line. That fair catch collected for Arkansas Tech.
We'll get about the 26-yard line as a starting point.
So it'll be first and 10 Wonder Boys from there with the score tied at 17 as we begin the third quarter. With you here on the EAB Sports Network tonight. Again, we'll be with you from Magnolia next Saturday night, 5:30 pregame show, 6 p.m. kickoff as Arkansas Tech will be at Southern Arkansas.
I'm not sure what they're discussing, but
probably trying to determine the exact spot of the football.
Yeah, I think. It looks like they're going to give us an extra yard here, about the 27.
Maybe
or
28.
28.
Maybe not.
No, they're going to back us up to the 27, which I think is a proper spot there.
So first and 10, Arkansas Tech from there. The Wonder Boys had 180 yards of total offense in the first half. 168 of those were passing yards. Tay Gatewood on first down. He will hand it off, running between the tackles for a couple of yards, maybe even three out to the 30. It was Deuce Wise. Tackle made for Henderson State by Tyler Strain. Second down and 7. Wonder Boys want to go quickly from their own 30-yard line. Hand again to Wise. Wise bounces it outside right. It'll be tackled short of the line to gain, but he does have positive yardage. Out to the 35.
34.
Made 34, yep. So we'll call that a gain of 4.
I like that 35, though, a lot better.
That would have been even better. As it is, it'll be third down and 3. Arkansas Tech from its own 34. The Wonder Boys are 3 out of 6 on third down conversion tries so far tonight. Trying to avoid a three and out to begin the second half. Man in motion, Matthew Rivera. Tay Gatewood, quarterback, takes the snap. Looking left, throwing left. Rivera makes the catch, but he's going to be stopped short of the line to gain. Wrapped up by Cameron Thomas. They gave him a lot better spot than I expected.
They gave him a good spot.
Oh, they gave him a tremendous spot.
Still going to be fourth down?
Still.
Boy, what do you do here, Sam?
It looks like it's fourth. No, they're going to say first down. They're saying first down.
Oh, my goodness.
I'm not sure they think much of that spot over on the Henderson State sideline.
Probably not.
But it will be a first down for Arkansas Tech and a Better Way Realty first down. To my eye, I had him catching that football closer to the 35, but I'm obviously wrong again, and I'm glad to be. 37-yard line is where they spot it. First and 10, Arkansas Tech from there. Hand off and running into a brick wall is the Arkansas Tech ball carrier. Deuce Wise on the carry, and that brick wall is named Cottrell Wallace, sophomore defensive end for Henderson State out of Bryant. He makes the tackle for a loss back to the 34-yard line, a loss of 3. And it'll be second down and 13 for Arkansas Tech from there.
They read that one right.
We go under 13 minutes to play in the third quarter. Score tied at 17. Arkansas Tech trying to defeat Henderson State in this stadium for the first time since 2005. Gatewood under pressure, flush to his right, and sacked. Quarterback sack recorded for Henderson State by Shaquie Robinson, senior defensive lineman out of Jacksonville. And the sack is back to the 24-yard line for a loss of 10. And it is now third down and 23 after back-to-back tackles for a loss by the Henderson State defense. Reddy's came into the night tied for the conference lead in quarterback sacks with 9. And Robinson adds to their total here, forcing Arkansas Tech into a very difficult situation now on third and 23.
Yeah, maybe get some positive yards here in case we have to punt.
Aaron Wynn ready on the sideline on third and 23. Here comes a middle blitz. Wonder Boys pick it up. Gatewood, now the second wave of rushers arrive. He rolls right, throws. It is batted away, incomplete. And on fourth and 23 from their own 24-yard line, Arkansas Tech will have to punt it away. The intended receiver was Jordan Jackson. Coverage provided for Henderson State by Randarius Terry. And the Wonder Boys will call upon Aaron Wynn to punt here on fourth and 23 from their own 24-yard line. So far tonight, Wynn has punted 2 times for an average of 45 yards per. Takes the snap from Gregor Jones, gets the punt away. A little more air under this one. Fair catch is called for and made at the 41-yard line. It is a 35-yard punt by Aaron Wynn. And the Reddies get good field position for their first possession of the second half as they will start from their own 41 with 11 minutes and 56 seconds to go in the third quarter and the score tied at 17. Next home game for the Wonder Boys will be Saturday, September 30th. That'll be another 6 p.m. kickoff. Northwestern Oklahoma State will be the opponent. It'll be Family Day at Arkansas Tech, also Saturday showcase for our prospective students. You can go to arkansastechsports.com/tickets right now to acquire your seat for that game on September 30th against Northwestern Oklahoma State.
All right, defense, here we go.
Henderson State, in the first half, accumulated 331 yards of total offense, 152 passing, 179 rushing. They want to throw here. Edwards deep downfield inside the Arkansas Tech 40. Catch is made by Caden Davis. Davis racing down the far short sideline and is forced out of bounds. They are going to spot him out at the Arkansas Tech 12-yard line. It is a gain of 40, no, maybe not 15. They're going to spot him out. It looks like at the 15-yard line now after further review.
How can you lose a big guy like that?
That makes it a gain of 44. And it's first and 10 readies from the Arkansas Tech 15. Edwards to throw again into the end zone. Another man is open. This one is just beyond the outstretched arms, though, of Chris Hatzis.
Short-armed it.
And it'll be second down, Henderson State, from the Arkansas Tech 15-yard line. 11 minutes and 30 seconds to go in the third quarter. The score tied at 17, but the long pass from Andrew Edwards to Caden Davis has the Reddies threatening to regain the lead. Henderson State led at one time, 14-3. Arkansas Tech has stormed back to tie it at 17. Caden Davis goes in motion left. Quarterback Andrew Edwards takes the snap, looking toward Davis. It's not there, so he's going to run for it. Going right, 15-10, Wonder Boys converging, and Edwards is tackled at the 10-yard line. Stop made for Arkansas Tech by Willie Miles. After a gain of 5, it's third down and 5, Henderson State from the Arkansas Tech 10. We spoke about it early in the game, the fact that the Reddies have had trouble scoring touchdowns in the red zone this year. Coming into the night, they had only scored 5 touchdowns in 9 red zone trips, and they've had some red zone trouble again tonight.
Get a big stop here.
A chance here for the Tech defense to come up with another stop. Third down and 5 from the Arkansas Tech 10. 3 receivers left, 1 to the right. They're going toward the south goal. Edwards takes the snap, steps up, throws into the end zone. It is incomplete. Andrew Edwards unable to connect with his intended receiver. Again, looking for Chris Hatzis in the end zone.
Try a field goal.
And they will send out Colby King and the field goal unit. King is 1 out of 3 on field goal tries tonight. He's missed one, and he's had one blocked. His successful try was a 25-yarder.
Probably on the side of the field that he'd rather be on.
This will be a 27-yard try from the right hash mark out of a hold by Chris Hatzis. The kick is away. It is good, and our new score with 10 minutes and 37 seconds remaining in the third quarter is Henderson State 20, Arkansas Tech 17. In the Alathus Realty broadcast booth, we step aside for 1 minute. This is Wonder Boys Football on the EAB Sports Network.
A lot goes into taking care of your property. You need equipment with more reliability, durability, and versatility built in, like number one selling Kubota BX and L-Series compact tractors, Z-Series mowers that deliver a quality cut, and Sidekick utility vehicles where durability meets speed. Visit your local Kubota dealer for a demo today. In the River Valley, see River Valley Tractor on Weir Road in Russellville.
Score you on select in-stock wheels and tires now at R&R Tire Express. Get a set of wheels for just $6 and score the extra point with a set of tires for just a dollar more. That's right, score a touchdown. Get the wheels and tires for just $7 right now at R&R. Just $7 gets you started on select in-stock wheel and tire packages. So get off the bench and get in the game. Score huge now at R&R Tire Express. Now open on East Parkway Drive next to Starbucks in Russellville.
This is Arkansas Tech Wonder Boys Football on River Country 102.3 KCJC, Dartanelle, Russellville.
So Colby King's second successful field goal try of the night and his fourth of the season has put Henderson State back in front 20-17 with 10 minutes and 37 seconds to play in the third quarter.
Got an update for you from Northwest Oklahoma. Southern Nazarene 27, Northwest Oklahoma 17. They have scored 3 points right before the half, and then they have come back with a touchdown in the third quarter. So to cut that down to a 10-point deficit.
Axel Robertson will kick it away for Henderson State following the Colby King field goal. Ryan Wilkerson and Mason Ross are back deep for the Wonder Boys. This one's going to go Wilkerson's way. He calls for a fair catch and makes it at the one-yard line. And so Arkansas Tech will begin first and 10 from its own 25-yard line here with 10:37 left in the third, and Henderson State now back in front 20-17. But another nice job there in the red zone by the Arkansas Tech defense, Kelly, to hold the Reddies to a field goal, and that's a big part of the formula when you're facing an offense as good as Henderson. If you can hold them to field goals to touchdowns, you've got a chance.
Absolutely. That could be a big plus for them right there. They're going to start the shot clock now.
Wonder Boys
better realize that.
In the estimation of the referee, Arkansas Tech's offense was a little slow.
I guess we can call it shot clock in football.
Reporting to the field. So it'll be Tay Gatewood in the shotgun. He awaits the snap. Hands it off to Deuce Wise. And Wise runs into Jacob Neal and Zach Dixon. They make the tackle at the 27-yard line after a gain of 2.
You know, between the tackles, we have not had very many yards, have we?
No. That's been some pretty tough sledding right through there. And it brings up second down and 8. Dixon and Neal are two of the veterans on this Henderson State defense. They both came into the night with over 100 career tackles. Hand off to Deuce Wise. He tries to get around right end, but Henderson State has it contained on the outside, and it doesn't go for a whole lot. As, again, the running game just tough to get going tonight for Arkansas Tech, as it has been early on in the season. Cameron Thomas with that tackle for Henderson State after a gain of 1, and it is 3rd down and 7 for Arkansas Tech. 9 minutes and 42 seconds to play in the third quarter. Henderson State 20, Arkansas Tech 17 from Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium in Russellville. Man in motion, Matthew Rivera. On 3rd down and 7, need the 35-yard line. Gatewood has it. Gatewood rolling to his right, avoids the rush, throws it toward the far sideline. I believe he might have caught it, but he's well short of the line to gain. We'll see if they rule it a catch. Now, they're going to say incomplete pass on the attempt to Rivera, so it doesn't matter either way. It's 4th down, and Aaron Wynn will be called upon to punt once again for Arkansas Tech as the Henderson State defense has come out and really asserted itself to begin the second half of this game. Aaron Wynn in punt formation. Wonder Boys ran about 4 plays and punted on their first drive. Now they 3 and out this time around.
Beautiful punt.
High spiral, fielded at the 22-yard line. Bringing it out for Henderson State is Devin Adams. Adams down the far sideline, and he's finally tackled at his own 46-yard line. A 24-yard punt return for Devin Adams after what was a 50-yard punt by Aaron Wynn. And It'll be first and 10 Henderson State from its own 46-yard line. And credit Devin Adams for making the right read that time and not calling for the fair catch. So the Reddies, for a second consecutive possession, get great field position to start. Last time they started from their own 41. This time they start from their own 46. Last time it yielded a field goal. See what happens this time with Andrew Edwards at the controls. The Henderson State quarterback calls for the football, fakes a handoff. Under pressure from Tyreek Jones on a corner blitz, he gets away from him, pivots, runs left, and goes out of bounds, short of the first down, but with a positive gain, into Arkansas Tech territory at the 49-yard line, a pickup of five by Andrew Edwards, and just great quarterback sixth sense there by Edwards to sense Tyreek Jones closing in on him, and he made the right move at the right time.
Yeah, he just made the right spin and got away from him.
It is second down for the Reddies. They need the Arkansas Tech 44 for a first down. Handoff is to Corey and Burrell, and there goes Burrell. 35-30, one man to beat, 20-yard line, and that one man will make the tackle for Arkansas Tech. Stop made inside the 20-yard line by Arkansas Tech's C.J. Palmer. But the run for Burrell is going to be counted at 32 yards down to the Arkansas Tech 17. And it is first and 10 Reddies from there with 8:21 to go in the third. Henderson State leading 20-17 and threatening for more. Hand off again to Burrell. A little jump cut back to the middle, and he is stopped after very little gain. Tackle made by a Wonder Boy who is now slow to get up a little bit. He's helped back to his feet. It appears that Kyle Green is okay. Teammates helping him back up. No gain on the play. Makes it second down and 10, Henderson State. Line of scrimmage remains the Arkansas Tech 17. Three receivers to the right, Elijah George, along with Timion Jackson and Cameron Gallagher among them. Now Gallagher shifts to a halfback spot. They hand it to Burrell. He goes up the middle and drags tacklers down to the 11-yard line for a gain of six. It'll bring up third down and four for Henderson State. Willie Miles in on that tackle for Arkansas Tech. And now it's third down and four. They need the Arkansas Tech 7-yard line for a first down. Line of scrimmage is the Tech 11. 7 minutes, 15 seconds to play, third quarter. Score was tied at 17 at halftime. So far, the third quarter has belonged to the Reddies. Tech defense trying to come up with another stop in the red zone. Man in motion, Timion Jackson coming to the near side. Edwards looking his way, throws toward him. It is caught, and he fell down into the end zone with a Henderson State touchdown. Timion Jackson able to reach his arms out and snag that bullet and then stumbled over the goal line for the touchdown, and Henderson State leads 26-17 on an 11-yard touchdown pass from Andrew Edwards to Timion Jackson. What hands by Jackson to be able to catch that football from that position. His body was out of position to make the catch, but his hands were able to make up for it. The extra point by Colby King is good, and our new score with 6 minutes and 52 seconds to go in the third quarter is Henderson State 27 and Arkansas Tech 17. In the Alathus Realty broadcast booth, we take a one-minute break. This is Wonder Boys Football on the EAB Sports Network.
Duval's Affordable Portable Buildings, the River Valley's oldest full-service portable buildings dealer. You'll find Burnett Affordable Buildings and C&H carports for garages, barns, carport sheds, and more. At Duval's Affordable Portable Buildings, they believe in high-quality buildings that last and excellent customer service that makes a difference. Visit Duval's Affordable Portable Buildings.com or just stop by 4151 South Arkansas Avenue in Russellville today.
When it comes to buying or selling a home, there really is a better way. As soon as you start talking with our team at A Better Way Realty in Russellville, you're going to feel the difference. Imagine if you had a great friend in the real estate industry, someone who genuinely cared about you and your family and was passionate about taking care of you. That is the philosophy of everyone who works here at A Better Way Realty. We want your business because we earn it, period. Discover what experience and heart can do with A Better Way Realty. Find us on Facebook and see the difference. A Better Way Realty. Real estate done a better way.
Performers from the Arkansas Tech University Department of Music will provide an evening of entertainment at one of the Arkansas River Valley's most beautiful points of interest on Saturday, September 23rd. The 2023 Brass in the Clouds concert, co-sponsored by Mount Debo State Park and the Arkansas Tech Department of Music, will begin at 6:30 p.m. next Saturday night at Mount Nebo's Sunset Point. The public is invited to attend, and Mount Nebo State Park recommends that audience members bring blankets or chairs for seating comfort. It's Brass in the Clouds 2023 next Saturday night at 6:30 at Mount Nebo's Sunset Point. You can go to ArkansasTechNews.com for more information about this and other goings-on at Arkansas Tech University. The kickoff by Alex Robertson comes down to Ryan Wilkerson at the 2-yard line. He's out over the 10, the 15, forced toward the sideline at the 20. He races over the 25-yard line and steps out of bounds long about the 27. A 25-yard kickoff return by Ryan Wilkerson. And the sophomore out of Elijah Fields, Texas, has set Arkansas Tech up there. First down and 10 with 6 minutes and 46 seconds to go in the third quarter. And Henderson State now leading 27-17 after that 11-yard touchdown pass a moment ago from Andrew Edwards to Timion Jackson.
Need to get something going here.
It'll be Tay Gatewood at quarterback. Deuce Wise is the running back. Receivers to the left, Caleb Tannis, along with Matthew Rivera. One receiver right for Arkansas Tech. That is Jordan Jackson. He comes in motion. Handoff to Deuce Wise. Wise running left. Tackle made for Henderson State by Jacob Neal at the 29-yard line after a gain of 2. Second down and 8 upcoming for Arkansas Tech. Wonder Boys offense has struggled in the second half the last 2 weeks. And bear in mind, this Henderson State team has very much been a second-half team so far this year, outscoring their opponents 41-7 in the second half through their first two games of the year.
And that continues.
Gatewood throws. It is in and out of the hands of Caleb Tannis. Excellent defensive job for Henderson State University by Colby Crawford, a sophomore defensive back out of Bentonville who got there at just the right moment to break up that pass. And it's third down and 8 for Arkansas Tech from its own 29. And the Wonder Boys offense in danger of another 3-and-out. Just have not been able to get much going at all offensively since halftime. And the Reddies have taken advantage with 10 unanswered points to claim a 27-17 lead. Gatewood has some time, rolling left, throwing. It is caught. Now let's wait on the spot. No, now they say incomplete. It was Will Stiegel, who looked like he had the catch at about the 35-yard line, then they ruled incomplete. And so it's fourth down and 8, and Aaron Wynn will punt it away for Arkansas Tech. And the second-half offensive struggles, really for a second consecutive week, continue for Arkansas Tech. Aaron Wynn on to punt it away, senior out of Somerville, South Carolina. A year ago, averaged 41.7 yards per punt for Arkansas Tech. This one is away. Bit of a sidewinder. Comes down at the 35-yard line. Received there by Devin Adams. Adams running left. Made a couple of men miss. Now he makes another man miss. And he's wrestled to the turf at the 41-yard line of Henderson State. And for a third consecutive possession to begin the second half, Henderson State will be able to start out beyond its own 40-yard line. And when you give the Reddies that kind of starting field position, it just makes an already potent offense that much better.
Yeah. Do not help yourselves by doing that.
And the root cause of that has just been the inability to get any first downs on offense. Not to mention a couple of nice punt returns by Devin Adams of Henderson State. Adams is a defensive back by trade, a junior out of Pocahontas. First down and 10 for Henderson State from its own 41. 5:48 to go in the third. Reddies with the ball and a 27-17 lead. Edwards throws, complete to Hatzis. He is wrapped up at the 47-yard line after a gain of 6. Tackle made for Arkansas Tech by Kylan Kreit, a freshman defensive back out of Newport. I believe that's the first time we've called his name. Line of scrimmage is the Henderson State 47 on second down and 4. Edwards has the snap. Fakes the handoff, runs around right in, and he's got a lot of running room. 40, 35, upended by Arkansas Tech's Jalen Pettis. at the 32-yard line. It's a gain of 21 for Edwards on the quarterback keeper, as it was a midline option, and Edwards read it expertly. Nobody outside to the right side to be able to slow him down until he met Jalen Pettis at the third level. So it's first and 10, Henderson State. New line of scrimmage is the Arkansas Tech 32. 4 minutes, 48 seconds to go in the third. Hand off to Jaquarian Turner. Rashad Richardson with the tackle for Arkansas Tech at the 29 after a gain of three. It'll be second down and 7, Henderson State from there. Reminder to join us again next Saturday night from Wilkins Stadium in Magnolia as the Wonder Boys and the Mule Riders, two of the great nicknames in all of collegiate athletics, will meet again. Arkansas Tech and Southern Arkansas, 6 p.m. the kickoff next Saturday night from Magnolia. 5:30 on the pregame show here on the EAB Sports Network, including KCJC 102.3 FM, the River Country KCJC website, and the EAB Media Group app. On second down, Edwards takes the snap, fakes left. Now a little shovel pass, complete across the middle. Looks to be a little bit short of the line to gain, as they have the receiver spotted down at the 23, which would make it third down and 1. Couldn't spot it positively, but I believe that was Timion Jackson on the reception. Javon Love with the tackle. Now Henderson State's going to send in some different personnel. They're going to go with their jumbo package on third down and 1. Edwards will remain the quarterback. In at running back is Jeremiah Davis. Hats is trying to hustle off the field to avoid 12 men on the field penalty. They hand it off, running straight ahead and picking up the first down on his first carry of the night. It is Jeremiah Davis, as he needed 1, and he got 3, maybe even 4, depending on where they spot this football. It will be a 4-yard gain to the 19, and it's first down and 10, Henderson State from there. This Wonder Boys defense has made a number of stops holding Henderson State to field goals inside the 20 here tonight. And none would be bigger than this one right now to try to keep Arkansas Tech in this game late in the third quarter. Edwards again hands to Jeremiah Davis. Up the middle and down to the 16-yard line with 3 yards. Trey White in on that tackle for Arkansas Tech. Matthew Minix was also there. Kyle Green was also there. Looks like they're going to spot the football at the 17 for a gain of 2, so it's second down and 8.
I think Coach Shipp was asking why they didn't call an illegal too many men on the field when they ran off earlier.
On second and 8, Edwards hit. Ball comes loose. Ball is loose at the 30-yard line. The Wonder Boys are going to recover it. It is scooped up there, and the Arkansas Tech defense does come through with that huge stop, and the Wonder Boys have the football back with 2:04 to go in the third. The fumble was recovered for Arkansas Tech by Vershawn Richardson. And I'll try to watch the replay here in a moment and give proper credit to the Wonder Boy who came through on that blitz and was able to jar the football free.
Ooh, sure needed that break right there.
We'll look to get that for you in just a moment. Arkansas Tech will go on offense with 2 minutes and 4 seconds remaining in the third quarter. And Henderson State leading 27-17, but maybe that'll be the spark that this Arkansas Tech team needs here in the second half. Tay Gatewood sends Dayton Keller in motion. Two receivers right. Hand off to Deuce Wise. He tries the middle and is stopped by Tyler Strain, among others. It'll bring up second down and long for Arkansas Tech. Still couldn't tell for sure on the replay. Maybe the live stats picked it up, and we'll be able to check on that in a few minutes and be able to properly credit who jarred that football loose for Arkansas Tech. Inconclusive on the replay. So now it is second down and 8 for Arkansas Tech. Line of scrimmage is the 36, a minute and a half to go in the third quarter. Henderson State leading 27-17. Tay Gatewood, three receivers right, brings Matthew Rivera in motion. Gatewood takes the snap. Here comes the pressure, and they're going to get Tay Gatewood. Tay, a couple of times tonight, has held the football a little too long. That time, he never had a chance. Snowed under by Dylan Dambuki. Back inside the 30-yard line. They will spot Gatewood down at the 27, and it brings up third down and 17 for an Arkansas Tech offense that has been really struggling here in the third quarter. The Wonder Boys had 168 passing yards and 12 rushing yards for 180 yards of total offense in the first half. And right now, live stats catching up to the action, but I believe they haven't even cracked 200 yards. So it's been probably less than 20 yards of offense here in the third quarter. Tay Gatewood now running for his life, and he'll be tackled by A.J. Zarate at the 29-yard line after a gain of a couple. Nice job there by Gatewood to avoid the sack. But the Wonder Boys will be forced into another three and out and another punting situation. And now Tay Gatewood is slow to get up after that tackle. Gatewood down in a seated position. And members of the athletic training staff at Arkansas Tech University, including Duke Walden, the head athletic trainer, will go out to check on the Arkansas Tech starting quarterback, Tay Gatewood. It stops the clock with 8 seconds left in the third quarter. And while they tend to Tay Gatewood, we will take a 30-second break. This is Arkansas Tech football on the EAB Sports Network.
Mr. Brake and Lube wants you to know when it comes to your engine, not all motor oils are created equal. That's why they only offer name brand motor oils that you can trust, like Pennzoil, Castrol, Mobil 1, and more. So don't pay top dollar for cheap generics. And if you're looking for work, Mr. Brake and Lube is hiring with all training provided and competitive pay. So call 219-5438 or visit 1415 East Main Street. Mr. Brake and Lube, your one-stop maintenance shop. Mr. Brake and Lube is an equal opportunity employer.
While Duke Walden, the head athletic trainer at Arkansas Tech, continues his evaluation of Tech quarterback Tay Gatewood, we turn to Kelly Davis for a GAC scoreboard update.
And start of the fourth quarter, it is now Southwest Oklahoma 13. East Central has just scored to start the fourth quarter. Now they have a 16-13 lead over Southwest Oklahoma. It is Ouachita at the end of the third. Ouachita leads 35-24 over Southern Arkansas. And Northwest Oklahoma coming back a little bit on Southern Nazarene. But Southern Naz has just scored again. It is 34-23, and there is 2 minutes to go in the third quarter in that game. And Harding all over UA Monticello, 49-12, 13:45 to go in that game.
8 seconds left in the third quarter here. Henderson State 27, Arkansas Tech 17. Aaron Wynn on to punt for the Wonder Boys. Another good one, wobbly spiral. Comes down to Cameron Thomas at the 27-yard line. He absolutely gets leveled, and a penalty flag is thrown.
I have no idea why that's a penalty.
Big hit delivered for the Arkansas Tech coverage unit.
Why would that be a penalty?
That was Ben Stiegel with the hit for Arkansas Tech. And members of the Arkansas Tech coaching staff asking the same question that Kelly Davis is right now.
He just tackled the receiver.
Looked like he had it timed up pretty good to me. But there is a lot of emphasis, and rightfully so, on trying to protect folks that are defenseless.
Player.
Yeah, and so.
Yeah, you better call for a fair catch next time.
That probably would have been a good choice. I imagine even if they do call a penalty, he probably wishes he'd call for the fair catch now nonetheless. We'll keep it here until they give us an indication on the foul if they're going to. The third quarter has come to an end. And I'm not sure they're going to give us an indication real quick, so we will step aside for a 30-second break here in the Alathus Realty broadcast booth. Henderson State leading 27-17. Back with the fourth quarter in 30 seconds. This is Arkansas Tech football on the EAB Sports Network.
Today, Americans are more afraid of health care bills than the sickness causing them. Sadly, unaffordable premiums and deductibles leave many feeling insecure, confused, and afraid. Hi, this is Becky with HealthPlanLady.com, and no matter if you're self-employed, individuals, or families, you will be happy when you reduce your premiums, have no copays, and get a check after going to the doctor. Call or text now, 479-886-2475. That's 479-886-2475. HealthPlanLady.com. I'll treat you better.
Back with you at Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium in Russellville, where it appears, based on the initial indication that we got, that the foul that was called against Arkansas Tech was fair catch interference. And I'm going to be real honest with you, friends. I never saw Cameron Thomas give any indication that he was making a fair catch. Kelly, I don't think you did either.
No. He caught the ball. As soon as he caught the ball, he got tackled. Never a fair catch signal.
But the official on the far side thought he saw one. And thus, it is a 15-yard penalty against Arkansas Tech.
That's a tough break there.
It's going to move the football into Arkansas Tech territory. I apologize. Actually, it's going to be spotted at the 42-yard line of Henderson State. As now the quarter is ended. That's the reason they're moving the football all the way down there. And now Arkansas Tech's defense getting hip to that fact. And so it will be first and 10 Henderson State from its own 42 after that penalty. And again, great starting field position for the Reddies. And I'm telling you, they don't need a whole lot more help than them.
No, they don't.
Arkansas Tech in that third quarter officially had minus 3 yards of total offense. Handoff for Henderson State to Corian Burrell on the first play of the fourth quarter, and he gains a yard up to the 43. It'll be second down and 9 Henderson State from there. They'll send Jaquarian Turner back in at running back as Burrell will check out. 463 yards of total offense for Henderson State, 177 for Arkansas Tech. Andrew Edwards, the Henderson State quarterback, taking a long look to the far sideline, has a play call to his liking. And now with 6 on the play clock, he receives the snap. Edwards rolls to his left, looking downfield, unloads. It is pass interference against Arkansas Tech. It was intended for Chris Hatzis. It looked like C.J. Palmer intercepted the football, perhaps. Now a lot of whistles and a lot of hand-waving and a lot of conversation about to take place on what we imagine will be a pass interference against Arkansas Tech. If that's the case, it'll be a 15-yard penalty on the Wonder Boys. It'll move the football into Arkansas Tech territory, and it'll be first down and 10 for Henderson State. As you can tell in the background, the green and gold faithful seated below us do not think very much of this call. But it is going to be made nonetheless, I believe. It is pass interference against Arkansas Tech. A little bit of a jailbreak there after the play kind of broke down. They just kind of all lined up around the 45-yard line, then took off on go routes down the field, and Hatzis was the man that Edwards spotted, threw it to him. The Wonder Boys defense converged, and pass interference was called. Moves it into Arkansas Tech territory down to the 42-yard line, it should be. 14 minutes and 12 seconds to go in the fourth. Henderson State 27, Arkansas Tech 17. It was tied at 17 at halftime, but as has been the case all year for Henderson State, the Reddies have dominated the second half. Now when you add in tonight's total thus far, Henderson State has outscored its first three opponents by a margin of 51-7 in the second half. Now some conversation, I believe, on the spot. The football's at the 43. I think it should be at the 42. They're going to talk that over. And what do you want to do, fellas? 43, 42. Let's pick one and play football.
Struggling. Crew's struggling a little bit tonight.
That's okay. I am too. Life is a struggle. They're going to put it at the 43. Hand off to Jaquarian Turner. Turner, with some help from his friends, pushes the pile down to about the 38-yard line of Arkansas Tech. It'll be a gain of 5. Tackle made for Arkansas Tech by Kyle Green after the rush by Jaquarian Turner. Clock is rolling, 13 minutes, 49 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Henderson State leading 27-17. Reddies have won 10 of the last 11 in this series. And they have not lost in Russellville since 2006. They have not lost here at this stadium since 2005. We've changed the name of the stadium twice since they've lost here. Hand off to Jaquarian Turner. And he is able to amble down inside the 35, and he'll have enough for a Henderson State first down. That is the 26th Henderson State first down of the night compared to 8 A Better Way Realty first downs for Arkansas Tech. New line of scrimmage is the Arkansas Tech 33. And the Arkansas Tech defense, again, painted into a corner. Hand off Turner. Turner runs right, spins out of one tackle, but then 3 more gold jerseys arrive to usher him to the turf. Matthew Minix, Blake Brown in on that tackle for Arkansas Tech. It's good to see Minix playing some more minutes at linebacker tonight after he had been a little bit limited in that capacity the first couple of weeks. But he's done a nice job, per usual, here tonight for Arkansas Tech. Minix came into the night with 111 career tackles, a junior out of Tulsa, Oklahoma. Older brother Mason was a four-year letterman on the offensive line for Arkansas Tech. Handoff on second down and 11, and it'll yield just a yard for Henderson State.
Passing situation.
That time it was Burrell on the carry, and the tackle made for Arkansas Tech by Tyshawn Nelson. So it's third down and 10. The line of scrimmage is the Arkansas Tech 33, 12 minutes and 3 seconds left in the fourth quarter. And a chance for the Arkansas Tech defense to force Henderson State head coach Scott Maxfield into a tough decision if the Wonder Boys can make a stop here on third down. Edwards takes the snap. Edwards rolling right. Rolling, looking, throwing, out of bounds. It'll be fourth down and 10 from the 33-yard line. Almost certainly outside their field goal range based on what we've seen tonight.
Pretty much we'll be going for it right here. Fourth and 10, big play.
And that is the case. Henderson State will go for it. The Reddies have converted on their only fourth down conversion try tonight. On the season, Henderson State is 4 out of 5 on fourth down conversion tries. They need the Arkansas Tech 23-yard line to pick up the first down. Edwards has three receivers to his right, one to his left on fourth and 10. Takes the snap. Wonder Boys rush three. Little dump off pass to Burrell. Burrell runs left, cuts back to his right, inside the 30, dives down to the 25. It looks like he is short of the line to gain. Tackled inside the 25. He needed the 23. And the Wonder Boys will take over on downs with 11 minutes and 33 seconds to go as the Arkansas Tech defense once again turns away a scoring threat by Henderson State. And now it is incumbent upon this Arkansas Tech offense to get something going. And that has been very difficult to do since halftime.
Time will not be our friend here much longer.
The Wonder Boys with -3 yards of total offense so far in the second half. Arkansas Tech has won a Better Way Realty first down in this second half. And Tay Gatewood is able to return to the field at quarterback for Arkansas Tech after he was shaken up earlier. Joined in the backfield by Deuce Wise. Pass is complete. First catch of the night for Cooper Smith, and he's got some running room over the 35 and out to the 38-yard line goes Cooper Smith, a gain of 13. And it is in a Better Way Realty first down for Arkansas Tech on the pass from Gatewood to Cooper Smith out of Bentonville. And the Wonder Boys have it first and 10 with 11 minutes and 10 seconds to go, trailing by 10. Gatewood in the shotgun, two receivers right, two to his left. Takes the snap, has time, throws across the middle. Catch made, Jorion Chase. He's close to another first down. Ridden down by Antonio Wiley right at the line to gain.
Terrible spot. Terrible spot.
They put the football at the 47-yard line for a gain of 9.
They just took 2 yards away from us.
There is an injured Reddy while they look at him in the Alathus Realty broadcast booth. We step aside for a one-minute break. This is Arkansas Tech football on the EAB Sports Network.
Quarterback, guard, running back. Every position has a role in building success. If you want a position where you can build success in your own career, Lexicon is hiring welders, millwrights, and many more positions. We offer free on-the-job training through our own Lexicon University so you can learn while you earn and build the career you want. Competitive pay, a great health care plan, paid vacation, a sweet 401k plan, and more. Find out more at lexicon-inc.com/football.
ABC Children's Academy is currently enrolling with 14 locations in Pope, Johnson, and Yell County. ABC provides all-day child care, as well as a variety of enrollment options for families, including Arkansas Better Chance for ages 3 to 5, plus more. Visit abcchildrensacademy.com for more info and come by their central office on 4th Street in Russellville to apply in person or call 567-5650. ABC Children's Academy, changing our world one student at a time.
The injured Reddy is Antonio Wiley, and he does require a little bit of assistance to get off the field here at Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium with 10 minutes and 47 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter. Henderson State 27, Arkansas Tech 17. Glad to have you with us tonight on the EAB Sports Network. Hope you'll join us again next Saturday night. We'll be in Magnolia for a 6 p.m. game, Arkansas Tech at Southern Arkansas. Tay Gatewood in the shotgun on second down and 1 from his own 47. He hands it off to Deuce Wise. Jump cut outside left for Wise. Stays on his feet over the 50 and is able to crawl down to the, well, maybe they're going to say now his knee went down back at the 49, according to the official on the far side. We'll see where they set the chains. Either way, it is in a Better Way Realty first down for Arkansas Tech. And for the first time in the second half, the Wonder Boys offense has some forward momentum. 10:24 to play, down by 10. They do spot Wise down at the Henderson State 49. It's first and 10 from there. Hand off again to Wise. Nothing up the middle. Bounces it outside left, tracking him down from behind Trenton Moore. And the tackle is made at the 46-yard line of Henderson State. Cameron Thomas helped on that stop. Gain of 3 will make it second down and 7, Arkansas Tech, from the Henderson State 46. We go under 10 minutes remaining. Henderson State has scored all 10 points since halftime, and the Reddies lead 27-17. Man in motion, Dayton Keller. Gatewood hands to Deuce Wise. Wise around left end. Has a first down and more down the far boundary, and he's forced out of bounds by Tim Jennings. They will say that Wise stepped out of bounds at the Henderson State 32-yard line, and it's in a Better Way Realty first down for Arkansas Tech. Checking in now at running back for the Wonder Boys, it is Ryan Wilkerson, who also has quarterback skills, bear in mind. Caleb Tannis is the receiver left. Three receivers right. Now Keller in motion. Handoff is to Wilkerson. Wilkerson runs right and is tracked down by Denzel Walter. Tackle made at the 27-yard line.
Clock at 9 minutes.
Gain of 5. It's second down and 5. Wonder Boys want to go quickly. Gatewood, the quarterback. Wilkerson, the running back. The handoff is again to Wilkerson. Nothing up the middle. Tries to bounce it outside left. And in that process is able to gain 3 yards down to the 24. In on that tackle for the Reddies. Again, Denzel Walter. Tyler Strain was also there. Jordan Eddington checks in at tight end for the Wonder Boys. Or perhaps we'll see if he's going to be the tight end or if he's going to take a direct snap here on third down and short. It will be Gatewood to take the snap. Eddington, though, lines up as a running back. He may very well hand it to Eddington here on third and short. Gatewood running right. Quarterback keeper. First down and more inside the 20. And down to the 18-yard line goes Tay Gatewood. It's another A Better Way Realty first down for Arkansas Tech on a gain of 5 by Gatewood on third down and short. Wonder Boys maintain possession. Clock continues to roll. 7 minutes and 50 seconds left. Henderson State 27, Arkansas Tech 17. And now it's the Henderson State defense that looks for a stop in the red zone. Gatewood. He will fake to Wise, throws across the middle, catch made inside the 10, and tackled inside the 5-yard line is Caleb Tannis. Tannis, with his third catch of the night, has the Wonder Boys first and goal at the 4-yard line after another A Better Way Realty first down. Wonder Boys check to the near sideline for the play call on first and goal for the 4.
Clock keeps running.
This Wonder Boys team, week after week after week, just will not go away. Is this the week they will break through? Gatewood fakes a handoff, throws into the end zone for Tannis. He makes the catch. Touchdown, Arkansas Tech, on a 4-yard touchdown pass from Tay Gatewood to Caleb Tannis. The second time they have connected for a score tonight. A penalty flag was thrown after the play, likely excessive celebration against Arkansas Tech.
You can do it in Division I now. Why can't you in Division II?
We'll see what the call is momentarily. When they sort it out, Austin Hosier will attempt his third Mr. Break and Lube extra point of the night. Mr. Break and Lube, when you need an auto repair shop, you can count on. The touchdown counts. It is a dead ball foul. Unsportsmanlike conduct against Arkansas Tech. That'll be enforced on the kickoff, so the Wonder Boys will have to kick it away from their own 20-yard line, which means Henderson State will probably yet again get great starting field position. 7 minutes and 1 second remaining after the 4-yard touchdown pass from Tay Gatewood to Caleb Tannis. It is Gatewood's third touchdown pass of the night and his 12th career touchdown pass as a collegiate. Austin Hosier's Mr. Break and Lube extra point on its way. It is good, and our new score with 7 minutes and 1 second remaining in Russellville is Henderson State 27, Arkansas Tech 24. In the Olathus Realty broadcast booth, we step aside for 1 minute. This is Wonder Boys Football on the EAB Sports Network.
Experienced installers needed. That's right. Arkansas River Valley Heating and Air is needing experienced installers. Candidates must have a minimum of 2 years' experience with HVAC installation, must have a valid driver's license, and be able to pass a drug test. Serious inquiries only. Contact Arkansas River Valley Heating and Air at 479-964-4004 or drop off a resume at their office. Arkansas River Valley Heating and Air is an equal opportunity employer. Johnny Story in with a thought from Olathus Realty. With years of experience, knowledge, and a network of relationships, they ensure you'll get the most for your house. So when it comes time to put that property on the market or begin looking for that next dream home you have, don't delay. Call Brent Pretty and the professionals at Olathus Realty Russellville, 968-5668, or check them out, russellvilleliving.com.
7 minutes and 1 second remaining in the fourth quarter at Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium in Russellville. And the four-yard touchdown pass from Tay Gatewood to Caleb Tannis, along with the Austin Hosier, Mr. Break and Lube extra point, has pulled Arkansas Tech within 3 points of the lead. It is Henderson State 27 and Arkansas Tech 24. Here just past the midpoint of the fourth quarter. Glad you are with us tonight on the EAB Sports Network. Now the Wonder Boys will kick it away in the Arkansas Tech defense. We'll try to come up with a stop and get the football back for that Wonder Boys offense. The Wonder Boys, this has been kind of the scenario each of the first three games, falling behind, particularly in the third quarter, and then trying to rally back in the fourth. The last 2 weeks, that comeback bid has fallen just agonizingly short as the Wonder Boys have lost their first two games by a combined total of 9 points, had a chance down to literally the last minute in both of those games, but fell just short, so 0-2 on the year. Henderson State, meanwhile, 2-0. The Reddies ranked number 23 in the nation, but right now trying to hang on against this Arkansas Tech team that just has so much fight. Austin Hosier will kick it away for the Wonder Boys. He has to do so from the 20-yard line because of the excessive celebration penalty on the touchdown. Correction, it's not going to be Hosier this time. It's actually Logan Timeson who kicks it away. His strong leg drives it back to the 15-yard line, received there by Jalen Abraham. Abraham, burst of speed, and a 31-yard kickoff return out to the 46-yard line of Henderson State. Tackle made for Arkansas Tech by C.J. Palmer. And it'll be first and 10 as, once again, Kelly, the Reddies with
once
great
again,
field position.
Past the 40.
They've made a living of that here in the second half.
Sure made it, has made it easier on them.
But the Wonder Boy defense has done its job on more than a handful of occasions here tonight. And now they'll try to do it again with 6:54 remaining. Henderson State 27, Arkansas Tech 24. Wonder Boys back in the ball game after that touchdown pass a moment ago from Gatewood to Tannis. And that drive came out of nowhere. The Wonder Boys offense had been completely halted in the second half before that drive. Andrew Edwards throws it across the middle. Catch is made by Caden Davis. Davis sidesteps one defender and makes his way down to about the 25-yard line of Arkansas Tech. We'll see where they spot this football. It'll be at the 24-yard line of Arkansas Tech. Nope, now they change their mind, say the 25. That'll make it a 29-yard pass from Andrew Edwards to Caden Davis. And the Reddies right back in business at the Arkansas Tech 25 with 6:28 to go. Henderson up by three. Edwards fakes the handoff, midline option read. This time he didn't read it as well as Jalen Pettis was waiting on him. Excellent job by Pettis, the sophomore defensive back out of Little Rock, to make that tackle on Andrew Edwards for no gain. It is second down and 10, Henderson State from the Arkansas Tech 25. Clock rolling. It'll be well under 6 minutes to go before the Reddies have to snap it again. They lead by three as we get late in this one. Edwards steps up in the pocket, and he is sacked. Sacked at the 29-yard line for a loss of four, taking him down for Arkansas Tech.
Big play, big play.
And setting up a third down and long, it was Rashad Richardson. And now it is third down and 14 for Henderson State from the Arkansas Tech 29. 5 minutes and 29 seconds to go.
I'll tell you what, if you can hold them to a field goal here.
It's interesting. From right here, it's probably four down territory.
Yes.
If they can get somewhere in the vicinity of 10 yards, they would still not have the first down, but that might be close enough to think about a field goal. We'll see how they play it. Whistles and the Reddies having trouble getting lined up correctly, and they're going to have to use a timeout. 5 minutes and 7 seconds to go. Henderson State 27, Arkansas Tech 24. From the Alathus Realty broadcast booth, we step aside for 30 seconds. This is Arkansas Tech football on the EAB Sports Network.
Arkansas Tire and Auto Service. We're more than just tires. Consistent, responsive, honest and fair. What makes us different? We're the ones who care. Trust our experience to know what you need. Professional and fast. See what we mean. Arkansas Tire and Auto Service. We're more than just tires.
Arkansas Tire and Auto Service, 2304 East Main, Russellville.
Stay with us for the Health Plan Lady postgame show. Right now it is third down and 14 for Henderson State from the Arkansas Tech 29-yard line. Andrew Edwards, the Henderson State quarterback, two receivers to his left, two to his right. He needs the Arkansas Tech 15-yard line for a first down. Edwards, hard snap count. Wonder Boys don't jump. Play clock at 17. Now they get a new set of signals from the sideline. Running back Jaquarian Turner moves over to the left of his quarterback, Andrew Edwards. Edwards, last year's conference freshman of the year, steps up in the pocket. The Wonder Boys have him again. Back-to-back quarterback sacks by the Arkansas Tech defense. And it's going to be fourth and long for the Reddies. Among the Wonder Boys on the scene, Braxton Johnson, Tyshawn Nelson. Yeah,
they'll go for it here.
Along with Jyron Stewart.
Need a big stop here, don't we?
They spot Edwards down at the 31 for a loss of two. And that makes it fourth down and 16. 4 minutes and 35 seconds to go. The game may very well hinge on this play. Fourth and 16 from the Tech 31. Edwards is going to go with a quick kick. He's trying to punt it,
but he can't get it away.
He lost the ball. It's going to be Arkansas Tech's football either way, regardless of who recovers this fumble, as Edwards had a notion to go with a quick kick, but he didn't give himself enough room. When you do that, you typically back up a few extra steps right before the snap, but Edwards did not do that, and thus he did not have enough room to get off the punt, and Arkansas Tech will take over at its own 34-yard line with 4 minutes and 22 seconds to go, and the Wonder Boys have a chance to drive down and tie it with a field goal or take the lead with a touchdown.
That's pretty exciting, isn't it, Sam?
What a fourth quarter it has been for Arkansas Tech. The third quarter couldn't have been a whole lot more dreadful. The fourth quarter has been a different story altogether. Tay Gatewood leads the Arkansas Tech offense onto the field. 4 minutes and 22 seconds remaining. Wonder Boys down by three.
Good drive here. Good drive.
It's all in front of the Wonder Boys. They just have to go get it. Gatewood from the shotgun. Brings Jordan Eddington in motion. Hand off to Deuce Wise. Wise up the middle. Tackle made for Henderson State by Jacob Neal at the 38-yard line after a gain of four.
And we've got a player hobbling over here.
It is second down and six, Arkansas Tech. Clock rolling. 4 minutes and 4 seconds to go. Dom Maroc, the offensive coordinator, is signaling in the booth two down from us, telling Caleb Tannis, trying to get somebody to get it, tell him to go down so that the officials will let Duke Walden come check on him. It is a leg cramp for Caleb Tannis. While they check on him, we will step aside for 30 seconds. This is Arkansas Tech football on the EAB Sports Network.
Farmers Co-op located in Russellville. Don't forget their Danville location. Mike Apples along. Mike, it is that time of year when feed is very, very important.
It sure is, and make sure that you've got your animals' needs taken care of, protein levels met, and all those things that you look for when it comes this time of year.
Farmers Co-op, we're located on East Main in Russellville. Don't forget their Danville location.
It has been 2,000 199 days since Arkansas Tech last defeated an opponent from inside the state of Arkansas. There have been a series of one-point losses, overtime losses, injuries at inopportune moments, just an inexplicable series of events. The Wonder Boys have played a lot of good football, including in those losses, since September 9th of 2017. But it has nonetheless been over 6 years since Arkansas Tech last defeated one of its fellow Arkansas members of the Great American Conference in football. Right now, it is very much on the Wonder Boys' racket to go and win this thing with 3:57 left. They've got the football, second down and six at their own 38, and they've got momentum on their side. Gatewood wants to throw. Looking downfield, throwing downfield for Chase, and he is wrestling for the football, and he's got it. Jorion Chase makes the catch inside the 30. They spot him down at the 29. It's in a Better Way Realty. First down for Arkansas Tech on the long ball from Tay Gatewood to Jorion Chase.
What a catch. Concentration.
Out muscled the Henderson State defensive back for the football, and it is first and 10 Tech at the Henderson 29. 3:23 to go, down by three. Gatewood has the snap. He fakes to Wise, lobs it downfield, looking for Jackson. Jackson couldn't haul it in. No penalty flag is thrown. Defense provided for Henderson State right at the goal line by Colby Crawford. And it's an incomplete pass intended for Jordan Jackson.
Both receiver and defender jockeying for position.
Stops the clock, gives the Wonder Boys a moment to gather their breath and their thoughts. 3 minutes and 14 seconds to go, down by three. Second down and 10 at the Henderson State 29. Tay Gatewood is the quarterback. Two receivers left, two to his right. Takes the snap, looking left, throwing left. It is caught inside the 25, short of the line to gain. Down at the 23-yard line, it is Matthew Rivera. It brings up third down and four for Arkansas Tech, and I would say the Wonder Boys are now inside field goal range for Austin Hosier, but they don't want a field goal. They want a touchdown.
Yeah, well, let's get that TD right now.
Dayton Keller and Jordan Eddington both check in. The Wonder Boys, two tight ends for some extra blocking here on third down and four. Now Mason Ross coming over to the near sideline.
Down to 9 seconds, eight, seven.
Mason Ross and Jorion Chase are the receivers right on third down and four. Gatewood calls for the football. It's a quarterback draw. Gatewood tries the middle. It's not there. He bounces it outside, and it looks like he's tackled short of the line to gain. They've got him spotted down at the 20 with a gain of three.
What
it
do
is
you do,
fourth
Sam?
Down and one.
Do we go ahead and go for it?
A field goal would tie it. It would be a 37-yard try from here.
What have you got to lose?
2 minutes and 7 seconds left in regulation. Henderson State 27, Arkansas Tech 24. And Kyle Shipp wants to think about it for just a second. We will pause for 30 seconds on this Arkansas Tech timeout. Wonder Boys down by three, back in 30 seconds. This is Arkansas Tech football on the EAB Sports Network.
Taking care of families. That's what the folks at C&D Drugstore have been doing in historic downtown Russellville for more than six decades when it comes to all your pharmaceutical needs. When it comes to compounding special medicines, R.D. Walker and his staff are there to serve you. And most importantly, if you need delivery, if you need curbside pickup, you need C&D Drugstore on the corner of B and Commerce in downtown Russellville, a 60-year tradition.
2 minutes and 4 seconds remaining. Henderson State 27, Arkansas Tech 24. Austin Hosier went onto the field for a moment and was loosening up as if he was going to be attempting a field goal, but that is not the case. That is just a decoy as the Arkansas Tech offense is going back onto the field on fourth down and one from the Henderson State 20-yard line. 2 minutes and 4 seconds left in regulation. Tech down by three. It's the thick cat formation. They'll snap it to Jordan Eddington. Eddington takes the snap, running right, churning those legs. It's all going to depend on the spot, and it is really close. It is really, 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 really close.
Oh, just, you got to give them a good spot here, fellas.
It is really, 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 like maybe even bring the chains out close. The Reddies think they have the stop. The Reddies think they have the stop. I haven't seen an indication yet from an official as such. Surely in this situation, they would bring the chains out.
Well, it looked like he had more momentum than that.
They're going to bring the chains out with 1 minute and 54 seconds remaining. If it is short of the line to gain, Henderson State will take over with its three-point lead intact. If it is a first down, the Wonder Boys still have a great chance to win this game. Here comes the chain gang with the all-important measure. You'll know immediately from the reaction from one sideline or the other. They stretch the chains, and with 1 minute and 54 seconds left, it is going to be Henderson State's football. Inches short. Inches short. Now Kyle Shipp is going to challenge the spot. He's going to challenge the spot. So here we go. Here we go. The video replay. It's first year in the Great American Conference, and for the first time, it is going to have a significant influence on an Arkansas Tech game as Kyle Shipp has thrown the challenge flag, challenging the spot here with 1 minute and 54 seconds remaining. And so they will go and take a look at the video replay. While they do that, we will step aside for 30 seconds. This is Arkansas Tech football on the EAB Sports Network.
At Centennial Bank, we believe serving our community goes beyond assisting with financial needs. We pride ourselves on being community connected and customer focused. Supporting our community starts with our employees. We enjoy rolling up our sleeves and helping make our community a better place. Our local bankers are a team that brings passion, pride, and dedication to our communities. That is why Centennial Bank is proud to support the place we call home. Centennial Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
1 minute and 54 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter. Henderson State 27, Arkansas Tech 24, and here's the rule. Play stands. First down, Henderson State. No change from the review. And I'm going to tell you, there's the introduction of this replay review at our level is going to be a little bit fraught with this peril, and this peril alone as compared to what you see on TV every week. We just don't have the number of cameras and camera angles and all the different things they have at the Division I level. It's going to be very, very difficult in a situation like this to find enough evidence to overturn a call.
Yeah, you may as well just put this review thing on the shelf. Forget about it.
It's just going to be very, very difficult to find enough evidence to overturn a call, especially in a time as critical as this, because now Henderson State is taking over at its own 20-yard line, 19-yard line, thereabouts, with 1 minute and 54 seconds left. And if they can get one first down, the game's pretty well over. The Wonder Boys also lose a timeout as a result of losing that challenge, and that means that Arkansas Tech is now down to one timeout left. And so if the Reddies can pretty much just possess the football here, they are in very good position to escape Russellville with the win. Andrew Edwards hands it off on first down, running between the tackles for a gain of a couple. Out to the 21. Ball carrier was Jaquarian Turner, who has been their primary running back here tonight in place of Corian Burrell. The Wonder Boys use their final timeout. A minute 47 left. Henderson State leads 27-24 in the Alathus Realty broadcast booth. We pause for 30 seconds. This is Arkansas Tech football on the EAB Sports Network.
Chicken Mart, your local chicken and more store, has some great deals to feed your family on a budget. While supplies last at both their Arkansas Avenue and Weir Road locations. Assorted flavored pork loins, buy one and get one free. Breaded chicken breast chucks, buy one bag, get one bag free. Breaded chicken breast tenders, buy one bag, get one bag for free. Breaded chicken breast fillets, buy one bag, get one bag for free. Supplies are limited, so get these deals while they last only at your local Chicken Mart, your chicken and more store at both their Arkansas Avenue and Weir Road locations today.
This is Arkansas Tech Wonder Boys football on River Country 102.3 KCJC, Dartanelle, Russellville.
So Arkansas Tech is now out of timeouts. It is second down and 8 for the Reddies from their own 21-yard line, and the only real hope for the Wonder Boys now is to force a turnover. Edwards awaits the snap. He's going to take it on a quarterback keeper. Running right, lowers his head, and will get a couple of yards out to the 23-yard line. A minute 35 left. Henderson State leading 27-24. The Wonder Boys, on what may turn out to be their final possession of the night, advance the football all the way down to the 20-yard line. Had a fourth and one play and came up just short.
I have no idea why the 40-second clock is not running.
Waiting on that play clock to start. The game clock is now down to 109 left, and the play clock still hasn't started. Play clock, now they want it at 25.
Oh, my goodness.
And so Henderson State, it's third down and 8, and they're basically just going to be able to kneel on it now because they can take this down under 40 seconds left on this third down play if they're smart about it, and then they can just let it run out without ever having to snap it again. Edwards is going to run straight ahead. He'll be stopped short of the line to gain, but the clock does go under 40 seconds remaining. We'll see how. Now they're going to say that Arkansas Tech, I guess, did have one timeout left. The board showed them with zero, and then I thought I heard the referee announce they didn't have any. But now they're saying that Arkansas Tech maybe does have a timeout. At least that was the indication from the official, and so the Wonder Boys will use a timeout here that we didn't know they had. It comes with 38 seconds remaining, and it will force Henderson State to indeed punt it away on fourth down.
We do have another final for you. Ouachita 52, Southern Arkansas 24.
So the best chance remaining for the Wonder Boys is to somehow block this punt or set up a return by Tyreek Jones. Line of scrimmage is the Henderson State 23 on fourth down and 7 with 38 seconds left, and the Reddies leading 27-24. The officials have whistled things dead for a moment. Now there's some conversation on the near sideline between the officials and Kyle Shipp, the head football coach at Arkansas Tech. And now,
oh my goodness.
Now the referee wants to bring over some more of his friends to have this conversation. Right now we've got 38 seconds left. Henderson State leading 27-24. It's fourth down and 7 readies from their own 23. We know that much. There has been considerable confusion here at the end of the game as to how many timeouts Arkansas Tech had left. And I have to imagine that's at least part of this conversation right now. Wonder Boys come over to the sideline to huddle up and discuss their strategy on what we anticipate will be a punt attempt from Henderson State. Three officials still discussing things in front of the Arkansas Tech sideline. Another official is over providing an explanation to the Henderson State sideline. 38 seconds left in this ball game. A reminder to join us again next Saturday night when we'll be in Magnolia, 6 p.m. kickoff between the Wonder Boys and Southern Arkansas. Also a reminder to join us at Tucker Coliseum at 6 p.m. on Thursday for Golden Suns volleyball as Arkansas Tech will host Henderson State at 6 p.m. Thursday. No admission for Arkansas Tech home volleyball matches. Well, whatever that conversation was, it continues now out at midfield as there were three officials talking it over right in front of the Arkansas Tech sideline. Now they're discussing it out at midfield. A fourth official will engage in the conversation. And I think momentarily we may be able to play football. Now we're going to the Henderson State sideline to talk it over. It's kind of like one of those traveling.
Interesting.
It's kind of those traveling dinner parties where you go from one house to the next. This is they're moving across the field here on that.
Progressive dinner.
I knew you would probably know that better than me. Yes, thank you. You could probably tell me all about it. Let's save that for a road trip.
I've had to be involved with one of them.
Yeah, I was afraid of that. 38 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
But they're fun.
I'm sure they are. Henderson State leads by 3, and they will indeed punt the football. With 38 seconds left, and Arkansas Tech desperate for either a block here or a big return from Tyreek Jones. There is still hope for Arkansas Tech. The board again shows the Wonder Boys with zero timeouts left. Here comes the pressure. The punt is away.
Not a great punt.
It is going to land on the Arkansas Tech side of the field, takes a ready bounce and roll, and will come to rest at the 40-yard line.
32 seconds, 60 yards to go.
37-yard punt by Colby King. And the Wonder Boys, with no timeouts, need to get down to about the 20-yard line to give Austin Hosier a reasonable try at a field goal to tie this thing and send it into overtime. The Wonder Boys have not defeated an opponent from inside the state of Arkansas since September 9th of 2017. That was in Arkadelphia against this same Henderson State program. And on that night, the Reddies were also nationally ranked. The Wonder Boys now with 31 seconds left have a chance to do it again. Take down a Henderson State nationally ranked team and end this losing streak against opponents from inside the state of Arkansas. First and 10 Tech from its own 40. Gatewood takes the snap. Gatewood under pressure, and he is sacked. And that's the one thing you couldn't do in this situation because the Wonder Boys have.
You've got to learn to get rid of the ball.
Wonder Boys, I say, have no way to stop the clock, but there's a penalty flag down. That'll stop the clock.
It may be on Henderson.
Penalty flag is in the vicinity of the secondary, not back where the sack occurred.
Defensive holding, maybe?
Comes with 24 seconds remaining. The one thing the Wonder Boys couldn't do was allow a sack. The one thing Henderson couldn't do is commit a penalty. And the two sides did both on the same play. With 24 seconds left and Henderson State leading 27-24. Here at Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium in Russellville. It was tied at 17 at halftime. The Reddies took control, outscoring Tech 10-0 in the third quarter.
They're really struggling on now maybe to where to mark it off from. Oh, no.
Well, they wave off the flag.
Why?
It's actually, I'm going to tell you this, it's actually to Arkansas Tech's benefit that they had the mistake because it stopped the clock for a moment and give the Wonder Boys a chance to get lined up. It may very well turn out to save the day for Arkansas Tech, that inadvertent flag might. That's the good news. The bad news is it's second down and 20 Wonder Boys from their own 30. Here comes the pressure again, and down he goes again. Another quarterback sack by Henderson State. This one by Dylan Dambuki back at the 20-yard line. It makes it third down and 30. Clock is rolling. 10 seconds left. 9 seconds left. Gatewood calls for the football. Sets himself. Throws to the far sideline. It is intercepted at the 35-yard line, and it's going to be a Henderson State touchdown. Picked off at the 35-yard line. He may or may not have gotten in. A Wonder Boy came in with a desperate attempt at the end to knock the man who intercepted the ball out of bounds. And the man who intercepted the ball for Henderson State was Josh Brown, junior defensive back. I think the Wonder Boys did get him out of bounds at the one, so the touchdown will not count. The game is over. Henderson State has won. And the Wonder Boys fall to 0-3, while nationally 23rd-ranked Henderson State improves to 3-0. Our final score tonight at Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium in Russellville is Henderson State 27 and Arkansas Tech 24. In the Alathus Realty broadcast booth, we will step aside for 1 minute and then come back for the Health Plan Lady Postgame Show. Wonder Boys lose. This is Arkansas Tech football on the EAB Sports Network.
I'm a teacher.
I'm a father.
I am a mother.
I'm Muskie Harris, former Arkansas Razorback. I have 26 years of recovery. Meth does not discriminate. Choose your natural state.
We choose Me Over Meth.
55,000 fans having a good time. 385 with a deadly secret. Meth kills more Arkansans per year than cocaine and heroin combined. Help stop this epidemic before it's too late. Choose your natural state. Choose Me Over Meth.
Are you looking for a great place to work that offers great pay and benefits, where you can make an impact in a safe, clean environment? ConAgra is looking for motivated, energetic people to join their team. ConAgra is recruiting industrial maintenance technicians to fill openings on all shifts. Positions start at $25.61 an hour plus a shift differential. Experience is required, so for immediate consideration, apply online at conagrabrands.com/careers. That's conagrabrands.com/careers. ConAgra is an equal opportunity employer.
A solid roof for your business is key to keeping your employees, products, and valuables dry and clean. If you're experiencing roof leaks that are resulting in damaged equipment, stained ceilings, and walls, then don't let Mother Nature get the best of your business. The folks at E&F Roofing offer free commercial roof inspections, but their experience is priceless for your business, not to lose productivity and extend the life of your roof. So contact E&F Roofing today for a free commercial inspection at 479-272-4069.
Feltner's Athletes Corner Half of Half clearance sale is now in progress. Save half of half off footwear from Nike, Asics, Brooks, New Balance, Keen, and Chaco. Save half of half or more on apparel from The North Face, Columbia, Patagonia, Mountain Khaki, Cavoo, Under Armour, Nike, and many more. Feltner's Athletes Corner, 2320 West Main Street in Russellville. Open 9:30 to 6 Monday through Saturday. All sales during this special savings event are final.
Watch your money grow with First State Bank's My Rewards Checking. Earn 4% APY on balances up to $25,000 and nationwide ATM fee refunds. Plus, First State Bank makes banking easy with mobile banking and drive-through banking 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Don't wait. Make the switch. Earn more interest with My Rewards Checking. Now, qualifications must be met to earn 4% APY. If qualifications are not met,
Back with you for the Health Plan Lady post-game show. Health Plan Lady, we treat you better. Final score tonight from Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium is nationally 23rd ranked Henderson State 27 and Arkansas Tech 24. And Kelly, when you look at the sum of these first 3 weeks of the season, three losses by a combined total of 12 points, your heart just goes out to every one of those Wonder Boy coaches and student athletes and everybody else involved with this program, because these young men have battled their guts out for 3 weeks in a row now and just come up agonizingly short on all three occasions.
Yeah, and, you know, there's going to be a lot of conversations about the replay and Division II, or especially in our conference, as far as being able to go back and look at a play like on that fourth down play. Did we get enough to get a first down? How can you replay it? But we got the ball back, had our chances, could not protect the quarterback on those losses. So you got to, you know, go back and look at that, improve on that. Go down to Southern Arkansas. They fall tonight to Ouachita 52-24. So, you know, they fall to 2-1. So it's going to be an interesting thing. So as far as undefeated teams left in the conference right now, it is going to be Henderson State, Harding, and Ouachita. And they were the preseason, I think, 1, 2, 3 picks in the preseason poll. So that stands true right now. Southern Arkansas and UAM dropped to 2-1 on their games tonight. But all these are finals for you. It is Ouachita 52, Southern Arkansas 24, Harding 59, UA Monticello 19, East Central 24, Southwest Oklahoma 13, and Southern Nazarene 42, Northwest Oklahoma 29. One game is still going on in the third quarter. It's Oklahoma Baptist 23, Southeast Oklahoma 3. So it looks like Oklahoma Baptist, they might improve to 2-1 as well on the season. So that's all the scores for you tonight from around the conference.
Let's take a quick look at the final numbers from this 27-24 Henderson State victory tonight over Arkansas Tech. The Reddies finished with 504 yards of total offense, 256 passing, 248 rushing. Arkansas Tech had 279 yards of total offense tonight, 248 passing yards, and 31 rushing yards for Arkansas Tech, although they did have 51 yards in a lost rushing on quarterback sacks, and so that rushing number sounds a little bit worse than it really was tonight for Arkansas Tech when you really just look at the running game. Henderson State had 3 penalties for 35 yards. Arkansas Tech, 2 penalties for 30 yards. The Reddies had 27 first downs. Arkansas Tech with 14 A Better Way Realty first downs in tonight's game. Henderson State was 6 of 15 on third down conversions. Arkansas Tech was 5 of 14. Both teams ended up with 9 tackles for a loss. The Reddies had time of possession of 34 minutes and 17 seconds compared to 25 minutes and 43 seconds for Arkansas Tech. Individual leaders first for Henderson State. Andrew Edwards completed 22 of 39 passes for 256 yards and a touchdown. Edwards also carried 15 times for 89 yards and a score. Jaquarian Turner had 17 carries for 79 yards and a touchdown. And it was Corian Burrell with 10 carries for 74 yards for Henderson State. Their receiving corps was led by Timion Jackson with 10 catches for 66 yards and a touchdown. Arkansas Tech led offensively by quarterback Tay Gatewood, who completed 15 of 28 passes for 248 yards and 3 touchdowns. Deuce Wise had 16 carries for 56 yards. Caleb Tannis, 4 receptions, 90 yards, 2 touchdowns for Arkansas Tech. Matthew Rivera, 4 catches, 85 yards, and a touchdown. Defensive leaders, first for Henderson State, it was A.J. Zarate with 6 tackles. Arkansas Tech led by Vershawn Jackson, who had 9 tackles, including 3 quarterback sacks and 3.5 tackles for a loss. Kyle Green had 8 tackles tonight for Arkansas Tech. But the Wonder Boys come up on the short end as our final score tonight at Simmons Bank Field at Thone Stadium was Henderson State 27 and Arkansas Tech 24 here on the Health Plan Lady postgame show. Kelly, any final thoughts from you?
No, they fought hard all the way to the end, and it's going to pay off. They just have to keep that faith and keep fighting on, you know, because it's going to happen. It's just going to happen.
Well, I enjoyed it as always. Well,
hopefully it's next week down in Magnolia.
That'd be a great time to do it. And that'll be our next broadcast of Arkansas Tech Athletics here on the EAB Sports Network. Before we get to that, we want to send along special thanks to the athletic communications professionals at both of these schools, David Sally and his outstanding crew at Henderson State, and, of course, Daniel Gallegos and his outstanding team here at Arkansas Tech, as well as Eric Moyer from the Great American Conference. All of those folks provided us with all of the facts and figures that we passed along to you on tonight's broadcast. We thank Brother Stephen Berry, who did a great job, as always, as our chief studio engineer. Thank you to the many sponsors, and thanks to you for listening. Our final score tonight from Russellville, Henderson State 27 and Arkansas Tech 24. Our next broadcast of Arkansas Tech Athletics on the EAB Sports Network will come your way next Saturday night, 5:30 pregame show and a 6 p.m. kickoff as Arkansas Tech and Southern Arkansas meet in great American Conference action next Saturday night. Until then, for my broadcast partner, Kelly Davis, I'm Sam Streisner, reminding you that Jerry says, fight on. So long, everybody.